Go Loud presents the Talking Bollocks podcast.
Go loud! What you waiting for? Put your back in it. Just a little more. Throw your whip in it now. Fill your body up in. Walk it hard and low. When you finish that.
The hip knocker.
What's happening, folks? Episode 23 of the Talking Bollocks podcast, brought to you by Go Loud. It's me, Terry Flower.
It's me, COB.
And this week, we're joined by the one and only...
Marty.
Guilfoyle. Marty Tinfoil, sitting there on the nip.
Marty Tinfoil.
How are you, pal?
Marty Tinfoil is something that I've been hearing since junior infants, man.
Is it?
Yeah.
So did you make that up?
No, a four-year-old made it up in junior infants.
Really, yeah.
And people now, adults, are still coming at me with it. And I'm just like, I heard this from a four-year-old. 25 years ago, lads.
I was like, I'm at that coming up with a cracker.
The point is that you can definitely come up with something better.
We'll leave it into the podcast.
By the end of this podcast, I'm going to come up with a little belt off of it. How's things anyways?
Martin, good. Geez. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for coming on, Marty.
Welcome to the family, lads. This is big. This is so big.
Co-workers.
Went up to the canteen there one of the days and I saw, fuck, it's the two lads off the internet. It's like, better say hello. And shocked at how sound you were. In a really good way.
Thanks for that, man.
I'm sure you get that all the time. It's like, you know, people meet you. Like, because you said you had a lad there around your place on his bike wanting to meet you.
Which is a bit odd, right? But listen, it's good.
I'm only messing. But yeah, we had a great chat. And then we messed around with, you know, the idea of getting me on. And here I am. This is great. Let's go.
I can't believe you agreed, but you're mad.
I know, yeah. We were only joking off air there about some poor decisions I've made in my career and that this is going to be top three for definite.
Yeah, it is.
Like, your management's going to be sitting there, not an outlet.
And the funny thing is that they're going to find out about this after it goes
after
up.
No going back now, Marty. You know what I mean? In for a penny, in for a pound, didn't it?
Right. Here we are. Before we jump into the zingers from last week, I just want to give a shout out to my little godson, Pierce, who's watching every week. I love you, lads, buddy. Right. Zingers from last week, Marty. You ready?
Right, go on.
Would you rather walk in on your parents having sex or them walk in on you?
Oh, them walking on me.
Why'd you say that so confident?
Well, because, like, you don't want to see how you were made, do you?
That's a very fair point.
You don't want to see. You don't want to see, like, a lot of that. If someone sees you doing it, your parents see you doing it, you know, maybe your dad would be proud of you. You go, all right, he's doing something all right then. Whereas, well, then again, if I saw my dad doing it, I'd be proud of him too because he's in his 50s. So that's kind of good to know for the future that. It still works in the 50s. That's a tough one.
Viagra is a hell of a drug. You know what I mean?
Sounds like a man with experience on that one.
Hey, I'm a stallion. I don't need any of that.
I'm like a horse. But anyways, 27% of people would rather walk in on their parents.
Hang on.
That's mad. Yeah. And only one person, right, I was expecting loads of this, one person said neither. And I'm like, that's the best answer you can give.
I think we should make a case about going through that 27% and calling them out. Like, who actually willingly says, I'd rather walk in on my parents than them walk in on
me? That's weird.
It's very creepy.
Yeah.
It's very creepy.
It's a creepy question, but I just banged it out.
No, it's a great question. It's a good question. Like, at first, you're looking at that and you're thinking, yeah, I have the answer to this. And then the more you think about it, you're like, oh, fuck, I don't really know what
you're talking about. Your man who texted us last night.
Oh, shit.
About when he walked in on his man there.
Go on.
Somebody texted us last night. This is going to be gruesome as well. And you know how awkward I am when I talk about this kind of stuff.
Yeah.
But somebody texted us last night and he said when he was about 5 or 6, wasn't it?
Yeah.
He was about 5 or 6. He had a nightmare and he went downstairs. His man and dad were in the sitting room and he walked in and they were in a position that was two numbers. I don't want to go into too much detail.
69! Get up there with that.
He says he still remembers now. So he was 5 or 6. And
again, though, that's a story that makes me happy because how old was he when it happened?
5 or 6.
5 or 6. So to know that, like, when you have a 5 or 6 year old, that you could be still, you know, doing a numbers game on the couch. Like, that's good to know, isn't it? Like,
100%.
Wait till the 5 or 6 year old is asleep, but then
is it not bad that
stick
he
on channel 999
that.
On Sky Digital, you know?
it's bad that he remembers that. That's a traumatic experience for that young
person. Oh, he's scarred, is he?
Yeah, oh, definitely. And then another fella messaged us and said he was in his missus's gaff last night and her ma had literally just walked in and caught him. And he goes, "Use jinx, those lads." So,
oh, yeah.
He had just been caught by his mother-in-law.
Oh.
But the order... The ordered food.
No, I'd rather be caught by my parents with my girlfriend than caught by her parents. You know?
Why?
I don't want her dad seeing what.
What you're doing with? He's breaking the missus up this week. And I'm not surprised he's taking the hip shot.
I know she's going to listen to this and they're going to be like, that fella we haven't met yet in Ireland. Fuck him, we don't want anything to do with him.
Pillow behind the headboard job, isn't it? Say nothing.
But 73% glad their parents catch him, yeah? Marty, do you wash your feet in the shower?
Like, yeah, I do. Actually, I was only thinking about this today because I was away there in Lanzarote and my feet have never smelled so good. And they always are washed nice when you come home from holidays because you're in the pool, you're in the sea, and you neglect them then when you get home, don't you? And I was
That's what he said.
And I got home on Wednesday and like, I made a conscious effort because I was like, my feet are so clean at the moment. Like, I don't want to neglect them anymore. So I'm lifting my feet up and I'm going in between the toes with the shower gel. And like only in the last, 4 days that I've kind of said, yeah, let's do this. Like, yeah.
So, you've only started last week?
Yeah.
No. It was, I could, once a month kind of thing, you know, you kind of go, oh shit, the toes, like, you know what I mean?
The monthly thing. Well, 12 scrubs a year.
That sounds better than monthly, doesn't it?
Yeah. Well, I only do it when I go swimming. Do you know, we're at the now sea swimming, I come back and I bleed and get down and scrub
everywhere.
That's
because the sand is in your house now.
Well, salt water and all and swimming pool and chlorine.
Well, then how do you wash your back then?
It's a good question. How do I wash my back?
The water hits you.
The water hits you. So if the water hits your feet, is that not all right?
Yeah, that's what I do.
Because the water hits all of you.
You're putting your body wash on and it falls on your feet.
If the water hits your back and it's fine, just let the water hit you like for 30 seconds, bam, you're done.
You're
sound like a scruffy cunt, boy.
Some people have sweaty backs. Like, if you've ever been sitting in a barber's and you're getting your hair cut and it's roasting, and you sit up off the chair and you turn around and there's this big sweat mark on the chair and you're thinking, oh, shit, like I'm mad.
Yeah, but they're always leather chairs.
They are the leather chairs, yeah.
But you didn't, oh, why wash me back?
You do. Show us how you wash your back. Go on. You're missing the whole thing. You're listening to this right now, all right? And you're having
right? And you can't reach. You push the elbow down.
You do.
Do you know what I mean?
Is that the scratching his hole there?
I wash me back. What are you questioning me for? Get off me back, Marty. For fuck's sake, it's clean enough. Jesus Christ.
Absolutely grand.
I wash me back and the Marty fella's calling me out.
Oh, since you showed me the technique now, we're all good. Like.
Yeah, that's a fair point. Right, 57% of people do wash their feet and 43% just let the water run. Like, oh shit.
Like you do with your back, yeah. All right.
Right, do you call it sun cream or sunscreen?
Oh, sun cream. Who calls it sunscreen?
Calvin.
Oh, you don't. Yeah. You American, are you?
I don't know, mate.
It's crazy,
someone,
isn't it?
Someone grew up watching a lot of Nickelodeon over here. Yeah.
The more I thought about it, I was like, no, do I call it sun cream or sunscreen?
I've never called it sunscreen in my life. Sense. Do you know that song? Always remember to wear sunscreen. That trend, that like big, massive song. No? That's the only time I've ever heard someone say sunscreen.
What
I actually meant it.
Sing it.
No, he talks in it. It's like it's the music and he's talking over it. I just said it. Always remember to wear sunscreen. That's what he says in it. Google it. Google it later. And
right.
Yeah, no, sunscreen.
Yeah, so I'll call it sunblock. No, not call it sunblock.
Sunblock.
No. That's
you, you'll go in then to impress somebody and call it sun lotion.
Sun soap.
Yeah, sun soap.
But 87% say sun cream, 14% say sunscreen, yeah? This one is stupid, man, because they're different. Stingers and nettles.
I don't understand how they're different. Right? No. Hey, listen. Stingers and nettles.
Are we talking the killer plants here?
What?
No, they don't kill you. Like, they give you
the yolks when you touch them and you get all lumps all over your skin.
Yeah.
They're
not the same thing.
No.
I've never heard of them called stingers before. No.
Stingers are the...
Stinger was a bar to me. Like, you got into the shop, you buy
the
a stinger.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's why I had to go out to Turkey.
Too many stingers and reflections.
56% said stingers, 44% said nettles.
People are sending me pictures of plants and I was like, it's the same plant.
Loads of them are sending the same plant,
To me, if you touch the two of them, you're going to end up with a load of bumps in your skin.
Yeah,
that's what a stinger is.
I think a nettle is more like cactusy. Like a cactus. No, like you can see the points. Does that make sense? No?
I've never heard a plant being on a stinger before. I was
really?
Like, yeah, no.
Well, what was the yolks on it?
56% said stingers and 44% said nettles. But the amount of people that said they're different.
Yeah. But
I'm going to
punch Harper around. Fuck you, Harper.
Now, to be honest, right, if you turn around to me and you said you fell on a stinger, I could probably guess what it is.
Yeah.
You know, I'd guess it was a nettle, like. I just feel like, why are you calling it stinger? Like, but I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, yeah.
So
yeah.
People are saying they're different.
Yeah, well, they are different. I can tell from the few just different names.
Oh, I think they're the same. You just call them different names. I got into this argument with my 6-year-old daughter, Marty.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, she was telling me they're not, and I was like, they are.
Is this the stuff you argue people, about with your daughter? Yeah.
Well,
argue
about
anyone. He would argue with anyone.
Oh, really?
I'm sure you noticed that straight away.
I actually have, yeah.
Well, come here as well. But I want to touch on the Coke Zero Diet Coke thing. Right?
But, and please.
Right, no, listen to me. Right, listen to me, yeah. The reason why I said that the same thing is because they're both poxy. Don't say Coke Zero tastes better than a normal Coke.
Normal Coke
tastes well better than Coke Zero. It's disgusting. Now, I get it. Diet Coke is septic, but the reason why I said about the same is because...
No, you said they taste the same.
No, yeah. They don't. Diet Coke and Coke Zero do not taste the same. But you can't the beat a Coke.
But they are. Normal Coke.
No, I get that. But some people want to watch their sugar intake, man. And if that person is picking a Diet Coke over a Coke Zero, then I don't trust them.
Coke Zero is the way I see it, if you're going to go out there and actually get a fizzy drink and you're like, I'll make a conscious decision to get a Coke Zero or a Diet Coke, you may as well just drink the normal Coke.
Oh, I think Coke just Zero is very similar to the normal.
It's similar, but you know the difference.
Yeah, definitely.
I don't understand the people that will order like a family meal from Domino's for themselves and get a Diet Coke with it. That pisses me off.
Yeah,
just ordered a large fucking pizza pal.
The stuff that's in that is more fucking harmful to you than what's in the normal Coke.
So, yeah, I have heard that. But can you give me the research and the evidence there to show
there's,
me that?
Yeah, right there's now? More cancerogens in there.
There's more what?
Cancerogens. It's more stuff that causes
that's
cancer.
In everywhere at the moment. Like everything you eat now these days causes that.
But that's what I think. If that's the case, you may as well just have a normal Coke.
But what if you don't want to eat that sugar? And you're like, fuck it all.
Some people rather do a Coke than Coke, boys. Believe it or not.
What about 7-Up 3? 7-Up 3 is great.
7-Up 3 is top of the range. The only drink I drink when it's sunny out like that.
7-Up 3. And the difference between that and normal 7-Up, now you wouldn't notice the difference between them.
I just think it's soulless that you're going out there and thinking I'm making a healthier option by going with the Diet
Coke. I never said it's healthier. No. Whoa. Are we twisting words already here?
That's exactly what
I never said that. I said if you want to eat less sugar. I didn't say it was healthier.
Yeah, but you're saying less sugar.
Hang on a minute, man.
It's like saying getting a hook off Mike Tyson's healthy and getting a smack of a house brick.
I'm saying if you're on a certain diet, you don't be eating loads of sugar. I never said it was healthier, though. Never said that.
Right, fair point, boys. Yeah.
But this is what it feels like to be your 6-year-old.
Grow up, yeah. You know what I mean? Just drink normal Coke, yeah? Put it that way, yeah.
Matthew, I've actually a very important question for you.
Okay, go on.
Do you piss in the shower?
Ah, who doesn't, like? Yeah. Everyone does, yeah.
Yeah, well, that's all right.
I was expecting you to say...
But everyone, you have to do it first outside of the shower. You get the first one out.
You're pissing twice? Yeah. How long are you bleeding showering for?
Well, sure, do you know that trick when you were a kid? Like, when you had your sleepovers and shit, you'd put someone's fingers in water and it would trigger the...
That's absolutely childish.
No, I know, but the point I'm trying to make is that you need to piss, you go, and then once the water hits you and cleans you...
Yeah.
You need to go again.
But see that whole putting the finger up water thing, like when someone fell asleep in my gaff, he'd shave their eyebrow.
Oh, you guys, do you know what we need? That was too tame.
I'd rather fucking water over somebody than saying put that finger in it, you know what I mean?
Right on that one. But I show you pissing the show, yeah. But I can nearly guess all the rest of them.
No, hang on. We have a good judge of character, me and Terrence, yeah.
All right, go
and
on.
I think we've already got you judged already, Marty.
Yeah. Well, going by listening to my mention, you don't. But anyway.
But right, hang on for a second. You definitely call it the cinema instead of pictures.
Yeah.
And you call it curbs instead of pads.
That's a fact.
Yeah, all right. Okay, you got me. Yeah.
Really?
Is this because I'm from the south side?
No, yes, it's just... Yeah. Oh, we need
no,
to say
it is. It is. I knew this was going to happen. I thought it was going to happen later on now, but I knew this was going to come up.
Off the bat.
It's nothing to do with the whole...
We're here to prove that the south side and the north side can get along.
We've had a few south shores. People say to us, I was ever going to venture outside the north in a city, and we've had a lot of south shores on it. You're a force from D4, though. You're from D4?
D16. But when we were growing up, we used to be such knobs. No, we used to be such knobs, and we'd say it was D4 squared.
Oh,
there's your maths.
What other old jingles have you got that we can judge them on?
Oh, do you know what? I had a few of them, and I fucking forgot all about them now. They'll come back to me.
I forget half the jingles. Yeah.
Does Calvin prep for the podcast at all? Does he?
No.
Neither do I. That's all me. That's the results from last week. That's all we have.
Have you got any more jingles?
That's all the results from last week.
Have you got one for this week?
Yeah.
Go, bro.
Of two.
Bro, I swear, let me say my one first. So I have a feeling you're going to get my one mixed up and then I'll be left with none.
All right, go.
Right, I got a bit of stick for last week over there because we wore sliders to the studio last week.
Yes! Why?
I'm going to get
there. Oh,
we wore sliders to the studio last week.
Oh, right? All right, yeah.
And I wore socks.
You wore socks with them now.
Yeah, well, I don't see the big deal.
Now, do you know what?
The comfort thing, Marty. Like,
okay, do you know what? Yeah. Things are comfort. And if you don't give a shit what people think about you, then
I wouldn't be going on holidays wearing them now. Like, you wouldn't catch me walking down the strip in Tenerife with sliders and socks. No, I wouldn't be at that now.
South William Street was out the strip in Tenerife last week.
In fairness,
it was about 40 degrees. Like, I beat that out there. Well, fairness, I was scalded.
I came over here on electric scooter last week. Look, I was catching a punter with fucking 0.8 for 100 quid. Honestly, yeah, you want to see me? I'm sorry, I didn't get nicked on the way over here last week.
Yeah,
last week. I went for a run, Marty. Yeah, so
Sliders and socks.
Yeah, I wish.
That's impressive, isn't it?
Now that's kind of why I wore them, because I was only back from a run.
Your feet were sore.
I jump on the scooter and I come over and meet him. But Terrence was ringing me and I left me phone. I have to go for a run, and gives me 2 minutes calls. I ring him back, and what's the first thing he said to me? I was like, he goes, "Sorry, I thought something happened to you," because he didn't answer. What's the first thing you thought happened?
I thought he got nicked.
You thought I got nicked?
Because it's not Marty. It's written all over him. He's like, he gets a hard time. He does. He gets pulled.
He just get nicked all the time.
No, he doesn't get nicked all the time, but you do get a bit of grief. Like, more than the average person, and he's nicer than the average person. Like, he's a scumbag, don't get me wrong. But he's all right, you get me?
Not like, a conviction. Not
if you were to line the scumbags up, you'd say he was the nicest one.
Yeah, do you know what I mean?
Coming out of Yumple. Not a conviction, I charge you to my name, and I got a hard time. And the first thing he says to me is, "I thought you got nicked." And I was like,
"I thought he got nicked."
Right, sound. I was out actually on a run there, but I'm ready now, let's go. And we bash out podcast.
So you were getting sick then for wearing the socks and sliders?
Yeah, and I don't see the big deal.
I mix and match. It's a comforting for us.
Well, like, sock on one foot and one foot.
No, but like, sometimes I put my socks on, my sliders, sometimes I don't.
Yeah.
Depends on what humor I'm in.
I think if you get to a point in your life where you're just dressing for comfort.
I couldn't give a rat's, Marty. Not a bollocks.
Honestly, Marty, next time you're in the gaff and you're not doing that, just throw your socks on.
I know 100% it's going to be comfy.
I know it.
Yeah, it is.
So that's my thing of it this week. Sliders with stockings, yes or no?
Yeah.
Right, fair enough. I'm saying, Matt, did you come to zinger?
What?
Did you bring a zinger in with you? Have you got a zinger?
No one told me to bring in a zinger.
What do you mean no one told you? You shouldn't have to.
Don't put me on the spot here now, lads.
Go on, off the top of the head, go. Doesn't matter how stupid it sounds. Go.
Go on.
Quick, fast.
Go. Marty, come on. Folks, say
nah. See, you're fucking in my ear now.
Spin 103 out of 98 FM. That's not a bad one.
Spin 103 out of 98. I'm probably gonna say spin. Like,
hold on a second.
No, wait. Hold on. Okay.
We don't have to.
You guys are harping on about the Christmas party.
Yeah, I can't fucking wait.
Oh,
middle of July. I can't wait for December.
Marty and Dad Conway spiked on the spot. Yeah.
Right. Okay. You just love Pat Kenny. So to everyone listening right now, you get to have 5 minutes with one of these people. You choose Pat Kenny or Ciara Kelly.
Right. I don't know who Ciara Kelly is.
Oh, do you know?
Neither do I.
What? No way.
I was waiting.
How do you know who Pat Kenny is?
I do know her, but I don't know her.
Don't act the bollocks. Ciara Kelly sounds like she lives around the corner.
She's on News Talk and she's she was a doctor, wasn't she?
Yeah.
She?
He does know
the
her.
The big fella knows, but I don't know her. I don't know Pat Kenny either. What am I on about? No, neither of them.
Okay.
I sit with you,
that was a shit singer.
Don't take that. Yeah, sorry, don't take offense to that. Yeah.
Right. You can take that.
Tell you what, we'll give you 30 seconds to think about it while we take his singer. What's your singer?
You had a fucking stroke.
I stroked one. You had two, you
don't. Yeah, but the other one isn't great, so it relates to yesterday.
Come on then.
Would you rather an orange calippo or a cola calippo?
That's a decent thing.
Orange all day.
Is that what? Are they the kind of ones we're going with?
Yeah. Oh, that's how bad it is. 33 episodes in, you scraped them up in the bag.
I know.
What we did at the start? We were banging out 6 and 7 zingers in an episode.
And then you were like,
next week's zinger box off.
That's all about the juice at the end, though, isn't it?
You know, someone put a good "would you rather" in it again, but it's a bit creepy, so I said,
come on.
They said, "would you rather have to watch your parents having..."
I'm not even getting into that one. I'm not even answering that.
Right, I have to ask it because you're reaction.
I'm going. I'll walk out, I promise you. If you ask this, I'm going.
Right, cool it. Right, Melvin.
We'll leave it there, but go ahead. Watch that singer.
Clippo. It's all about the juice at the end, isn't it?
That's the only reason
anyone gets a clippo is to have the juice at the end.
The end.
The problem is that I'm never patient enough to let there be enough juice in them. Biting into the fucking thing.
Yeah.
It's going to be orange.
But you ever seen when you peel it and it's John, because it's all frozen then, and you're squeezing it and you're squeezing it, and the thing pops out with each
Have you ever stuck it in the microwave for 10 minutes or 10 seconds? 10 minutes.
Stick your Calippo in the microwave, don't you?
I'm telling you now, right? Or Ben and Jerry's. Trust me on this one.
Hang on for a second.
Trust me. No. You're laughing. You're laughing.
You're a fully grown adult, yeah? Yeah. You have the right to vote in this country, and you're sticking ice pops in the microwave.
You just admitted the best part of it is the juice. So why don't you get more juice? Instead of fucking standing outside and holding it. You're ganging up on me now.
You're going to believe it.
Yeah, for real.
10 seconds.
You're digging your own grave.
10 seconds. Stick the Calippo on its back in the fucking microwave. Let it cool down a little bit. Cool down. It's funny, it's already cool. And then let the juice, and then enjoy it. It slides perfectly. You don't have to like be grab. You know, don't say when you get a Calippo straight out of the freezer, it's frustrating. You're holding it and you're waiting.
But your body temperature, your hand.
Your body temperature in a microwave. You have the patience. It's not part of the experience.
It is.
You're squeezing the fucking thing.
But the idea was you back against
your
nip,
you're scraping your teeth off the top of it and everything.
Mate, I'm only just saying, like when you squeeze it, you got a little sift jab off it. I take a sift jab off it rather than putting it in the microwave.
But then you're grazing your teeth off the top of it.
Fucking me.
No, not fuck it. No.
You go to talk. You look at Tyrant, she's fresh.
Yeah, that's an expensive fucking Calippo.
Yeah, fuck
Jesus,
it.
This, the lads in here now obviously making big bucks off this podcast.
Yeah, like, honestly,
we'll chew a Calippo and fuck off to Turkey to get a fix.
So, if that's boxed up, you said orange. What did you say?
Orange as well.
I'm a cola Calippo. Yeah,
you're just going cola because we went
said orange.
Bro,
yeah,
well, you only said it to you yesterday. I had a cola Calippo.
I don't remember you saying it, but
what about
the lime one? Did the lime one never pop into the
lime? Is that a lime Calippo?
Yeah, a green one.
Oh, we have that.
Yeah. That's very fancy now, isn't it?
Yeah. That must be a Southside king.
You wouldn't get that in the flats, Marty. No. I'll tell you that much.
The whole Pat Kenny thing. How come we haven't met Pat Kenny yet? What's
Where's Pat Kenny, boy? Someone put us on to him.
In the building here, we've got the three floors. So we've got floor three, which is scary. News talk.
Right.
Scary.
Sure, yeah, keep that.
Grown adults down there.
Grown adults. Actual adults, yeah.
Yeah, they're big business.
Floor four. Is the fun floor? Is
the fun floor.
Well, no, the fifth floor is good crack because you get the hot chocolates and stuff.
What floor are we on?
We're on the fifth floor. Yeah,
this is a good crack floor. Yeah.
This is a good crack floor as well. Floor three now. That's where Pat Kenny is gonna be.
Yeah.
So, like, I would love to Derry's to just walk down there.
Oh, if he's down there,
100 quid I'll do it right now with you.
100 quid.
Well, he's definitely not here now. It's 7:15 when we're recording this. Pat Kenny's in bed now.
He's in bed. He doesn't have to do all that time.
No,
that
he knows what he's doing.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, he better be at the Crimbo party.
Yeah, he's there. He's been at the last couple of ones.
Yeah, we're going to have some crack with him.
Yeah. What are they like, Marty? What's the Crimbo parties like?
Good crack. They're good crack.
Yeah.
I know you guys are thinking straight off the bat, you're thinking the company credit card's going to be behind that sale.
You better believe it.
Hey, we're liabilities, honestly. I wouldn't trust us.
Yeah, you couldn't trust
I can't believe again. I can't believe they've already agreed to us in the middle of July that we're allowed to go in December.
Oh, that's
because we're sure if you got the gig at the start of December, you'd be able to go. It's usually the first week of December, so
is it?
You can't be excluded, like, you know what I mean?
I'd exclude us, and that's on my mind.
But nobody needs to know that. You give them a reason to exclude you for the next Christmas party.
Yes, it's wrapped up. We're talking from experience, here, mate.
No, I've been to them all. I'm all right. Most of them. I'm not kidding.
Hasn't made the one more us yet.
For that. Moving on, I want to give a quick shout out to Emma Brennan at the Olympics.
Yeah,
it's a cunt, isn't it? It stings like, but it's a pity, but Emma, you're at the end the country proud, your family proud, the area proud, you're an absolute legend. Sick for him, but.
Yeah, very sick for him, but your man's favourite to win the gold,
he is, he's top class.
He took a round off him as well, so like it's...
the interview after.
Mate, it's heartbreaking.
Lump in the throat.
But come here, he's an inspiration, you know what I mean? He said he wasn't ready 4 years ago. He invested in himself. He got the head down. He took a credit union loan out the back himself. And look, sure, he's over in Tokyo now, isn't he? So, look, take a story. Go back and watch his interview. He said if he can inspire one or two people to invest in themselves and follow their dream and chase their dream, well, then his job is done. So, fair fucking play to Emma. Okay, don't beat yourself up over it, mate. Just getting there was a big fucking achievement.
100%. And Kelly is up next.
Yeah.
When's Danny going on Kelly's on Friday, is it?
I don't know.
Kelly Hardington. But best of luck to Kelly as well. Better luck now.
Mm.
But you'd fancy Kelly take on the gold.
Well, we'll see what happens.
No
we'll
pressure.
Hopefully, hopefully. Yeah,
no
we'll
pressure.
See,
bring
we'll
it back to the
goes.
North in a city, Kelly. Yeah,
yeah we'll see how it goes.
But yeah, that's that boxed off.
Someone asked, we'll be doing agony and give relationship advice. But this is the weird part. Relationship advice to girls on how to get fellas.
That's no, that makes sense though, doesn't it?
No, obviously, mate. Yeah, I'd agree.
Kind of, but like, what am I going to say? Like, oh, yeah, go out and get your nails done
you
better.
You have a girlfriend, do you?
I do, yeah.
Yeah, so you can tell a girl how she got you. A fine fella like yourself.
Yeah.
The women out there in Dublin pulling a lad like you because you're giving out advice.
Yeah. Marty, you don't be flirting with him.
Yeah. What's the story with that? What's the story with guests coming on and flirting with you?
I'm saying, look careful, lads. We've got stuff off air now.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about. Yeah. Well,
now, my poor boy, she's bleeding at the end of the short end of the stick. She's doing a life sentence with me. I don't know. Like, think about how much I argue. Imagine being in a relationship with me. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, shit.
No, poor young one, like.
No, really. Because they can't argue with anyone.
I'm telling you.
And did anybody ask for, like, advice, like specific advice?
I don't know. No, I wouldn't even know.
They literally just went, Calvin, Terrence, tell us how to get a girl. How do I get a guy?
Be an agony
aunt. But boys need to approach blokes more. That's what I'm saying.
No. That's a thing now. That is.
Yeah, it is a thing.
That
they don't approach fellas.
No, they do. Oh, I think it's 50-50 now, playing field.
Oh,
it's great.
See, I've been out of the game too long, Marty. I remember back in the day, young ones would say, like, I'd never text a fella. And I'd be like, but like, how would you expect to get anywhere?
How long are you at your missus?
7, yeah, no.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, thanks, Terrence. Yeah, but there you go.
How do you know?
Don't you worry about that. And I only know him 6 months.
You probably know her birthday as well, do you?
You better believe and no better man.
BPS from my
mom. Yeah, no, they're not that showing anymore.
No,
that's all social media. Poor Ted Muldrun the weekend. That's all you got on me. Question mark.
And the eyes emoji.
That eyes emoji, yeah.
Just
no,
letting them know.
I met my girlfriend because she came up to me. So there you go.
You're punching.
I am punching. Hey, hold on a second. You can't take my caption and use it against me.
I said on my Instagram that I'm punching.
So no, you can't
Marty,
use that against me.
I'll give it to you. You're a good looking bloke, yeah, and you're in good nick. I wouldn't bring me board around you. Because you'd be like, fuck that. But you're still punching. The other half is a little smelty.
Yeah. Nah, she's gorgeous. Yeah, she is. She's nice.
How'd you back that one, Marty? What's the story there?
She came up to me in the gym.
Oh,
yeah.
In the gym, yeah.
That's just how we met that way. So I'm not going to go.
How long you were?
We've known each other now. Oh my god, what, a year and a half? So, like, she's from America, so that's probably what you fancy about her.
Probably is.
Yeah,
Marty gets a good crack, aren't
you? She is. To be fair, she is funny. She's got her audience online. The whole lot. She does the American versus Irish jokes, and
yeah,
she's good cracking.
That Matt Gullible,
do you guys watch the NFL?
No,
because we're grown men.
Yeah.
The NFL.
Yeah.
I'm only messing with you.
I was going to say that's
that basketball, baby.
American football.
Her, so the New England Patriots.
Yeah.
Yeah. Her mom used to be a cheerleader for them.
Fuck off.
Yeah.
So. Tom Brady and all. What's up?
Tom Brady. Yeah. See, you know what's going on.
Yeah. I know what's going on, bro. Yeah. I'm watching those.
So my housemate's a huge New England Patriots fan. So he's dying to meet my girlfriend's mom. Rather than like hang out more with my girlfriend.
Do you not think it's a bit cringy that there's like people in Ireland following American sports?
I love basketball though.
I like basketball as well.
But if you look at someone like me, right, I work nights. So the American sports then, when I finish work, they're on because they're back in time. Do you know what I mean? Back in time.
So is that the only reason?
They're in 2008.
Well, that's how we got into basketball, huh?
You said that back in time. They're in 2008. Eh?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, like, I miss the Champions League and everything because of work. Like, you know what I mean? So I don't miss it. Like, I have it on the studio.
Have you ever been to American games?
No, never.
Never?
No.
I actually wanted to tell the story and I didn't know when I would. And then you have to send me up perfect for a match. You look Bruno over there with the message. But I went to a baseball game before, right?
A proper MLB game?
Proper. Yeah. In Oakland.
No way.
Yeah, it was the Oakland Athletics and the San Francisco Giants. So this would have been like Liverpool versus Everton.
Yeah.
Would it,
Yeah, proper like rivalry, It's
a game of baseball though, like,
Well, yeah, essentially. But Oakland is fucking one of the roughest parts of America, you know what I mean?
To know that, yeah.
And so it's San Francisco and then across the Bay of Oakland. So they call it the Battle of the Bay. And this is when I was walking in San Francisco and all the people in the shop were like, oh, you going to the game? And I was like, oh, yeah, I might go. And they're like, oh, it's sold out. I was like, is it? Yeah. You know what that means, Terrence?
You know what that man a bunk in anywhere in the world.
So I was like, yeah, we'll go to that. So me board, a few of the boys, we all went. And they were like, we haven't got tickets. What are we going to do? I was like, what do you mean, what are we going to do? Come here and I'll show you this, right? So over there in America, to take a mad serious with the security and all. So you're queuing up to get in. And have you ever bunked in anywhere, Marty? That's something I wanted to say about him. You've never bunked on the Lewis in your life.
It's fact you haven't. That's a fact. He's dead right.
Am I right? I don't mean laughing. I'm dead serious.
No, you're right. Like, it's not something that I've ever been asked either.
Yeah. Have you ever bunked into anywhere in your life?
No, but there was a...
Now, make sure your management teams can't be watching that.
But the answer's no. Like, I haven't.
Yeah, no, see, no, but see, that's how we know you, you know? We know you better than you know yourself.
No, we don't, though. Yeah. That's the thing. But go on.
But anyway. I was like, I'll show you how you bunk in. Yeah, because the boys always...
Into an MLB game.
Mate, I bunked into better places than that. But the boys always question, like, how do you do in this, that, and the other. And it's all about confidence. You have to believe you're going to get in. Or you have to make it look like you're supposed to be there.
So did you get, like, a high-vis jacket?
No, high-vis jacket, mate. Would you stop? You just blend in incognito. So,
incognito.
How do you walk over there,
people
right?
From the south side listening going, what's incognito? Yeah. What's incognito? Yeah. Who's he?
So they have security checkpoints over there, as in you go in and you get searched and go through a metal detector. It's like going on the flight. And then you go up and get your tickets scanned.
Get into a baseball game.
Yeah, mate. They take a problem serious, bro. Yeah.
Oh, shit. So, that's mad, then.
Just get a hot dog and watch the shittest sport in the world.
Like, oh, mate, it's terrible. It's like cricket.
Yeah.
But come out.
It's so bad.
We queued up, right? And the boys were like, what do you do? What are we going to do with no tickets? I goes, you'd be grand. So you walked up and your man serious. You say, you go through the metal detector. They don't ask you for a ticket. And then we go up to the turnstile. I'm not even exaggerating. Your man was about 80 at the turnstile, right? And I goes to one of the boys, see that fella there? I goes, just walk around him and open that gate behind him. And your man's there checking tickets, yeah, letting people through the turnstile. And one of the boys literally walked straight around him, opened the gate, and we all just walked straight in. And your man looked at us. Your man looked at us walking boy, didn't say anything, yeah? So we're in there, we got these seats. We just kept walking along the rows of seats until we seen empty seats. We sat there, and then like someone come along and looked at their seats, and we just keep moving along. So three of us were sitting there, right? One of the boys is locked, having a great time, and all the Americans are loving it. Now, he's a big culty. Shout out to Barty, yeah. he was sitting there, and he was locked, drinking cans, and all the Americans were loving it. And they're like, hey, that Irish guy, yeah, and he's drinking. We're having a great time. And the security were looking, and they're laughing at us, and they're like, yeah, how much do you pay for the tickets? And I was like, pay for tickets. I was like, we walked in, and they couldn't believe it. Fella sitting beside it goes, I paid $200 for this seat, he said.
And you were probably up at the top of the stand, really?
No, I was sitting right at the front.
Oh, fuck.
And we could see...
I was going to say, because tickets to those games are expensive. Like, no, yeah.
$200 you pay for that seat, right?
For a baseball.
And I'm sitting there like, well, this costs us nothing to get in hell. So Barty was locked and he's having a great time and he's buzzing off the crowd and security are having a buzz with him or whatever. And he stands up and everyone's cheering, but he had a can in his hand and the security goes, do you bring that beer from outside? And he goes, yeah. And he goes, yeah, you're not allowed to do that. Puts a set of cups on him. He gets nicked, right? He got nicked and brought to Oakland prison for the night. And Oakland's like one of the roughest parts in America.
Hold on. You're telling me that you guys snuck into a baseball game and the reason why your friend got arrested is because he snuck a can in?
Yeah.
He's showing it off in the fucking stadium.
But you're allowed drink in there. You're allowed boy drink in there. You just can't bring drink in from outside.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And I didn't know that was like an offense. Like,
And he got nicked, right? Charge-y and all.
It's the first time I've ever heard someone say they got nicked. I've never heard that expression before.
Never heard someone say, what do you say?
Where are you from?
Where are you from?
What planet are you living on?
What planet are you living on? Keep going.
I was like, fucking paranoid.
No, because he makes you a bit mad. But what do you say if you don't, if you say...
If you get arrested, like...
If one of the boys got nicked.
If he got arrested putting... thrown in the back of a car, like, yeah, I would never
you
say
you never say you got nicked.
No,
like, this is gas.
I've got a feeling like all your listeners are going to be like, this fucking idiot over here hasn't a fucking
probably would, man. You're not going to lie,
yeah, yeah. Sorry.
Yeah, look, and you walked into it.
I walked into it.
You can't get you out of this.
No,
but well, anyway,
your friend got nicked.
He got nicked, yeah. He got nicked. And see, when you see when he was getting nicked, yeah, they were like, you with him. I was like, no.
But to be fair, if that happened to me, I'd be like, don't act like you
know. No, they were stretch.
Oh, the fucking trees. And then you ask for your tickets, and then you get caught in CCTV walking behind an old man. You took advantage of an old man.
I didn't take advantage of him.
You said, look, this lad over here is like 80. We'll get past him.
He was the only fella there. I couldn't go to a different
No, you
so
mentioned his age,
choice.
Man. You mentioned his age here.
Marty's trying to hang you out.
You picked the vulnerable one, you did. Yeah.
But anyway,
this is for the microwave comment earlier.
I said there, right? Marty, I sat there for the day and I mean it was beaming out. Yeah, it was about 30 degrees sitting there, sun worn to bits, and when I left it was pitch black out and freezing. The game lasted about 8 hours
Oh, stop,
and
man,
nothing
yeah.
happened until the very end. the ninth inning or whatever it was. It was two home runs, and that was it. And I was like, I'm sitting here, I'm wasting a whole day of my life in this sport. It's fucking shite.
But not many, people can say they went to one, so like.
Not many people say they can bunk into one either.
No.
Poor Barty's doing a stretch in Oakland, yeah. Don't know what's happened to him. The boys are all probably doing a train on him. All the Crips and the Bloods.
Yeah, knocking right? the hips up.
And the next day, bump into him. What happened then? He said he had a great time. He was pointing a holding cell. There was about 30 of them. So they were all calling him Irish in there, yeah? So
they're like, hey, Irish. He would have been
stuck out like a sore thumb. He had a bleeding farmer's hand and all, you know what I mean? So he was putting a holding cell, and they took him out of that cell to process him, and they put him in a cell on his own. And he said, when they processed him, he said, will you put me back in with them? I don't want to be on my own. No. So he got put back in the holding cell, and then they let him out.
So he's made friends for life.
Basically, yeah.
Imagine going for a drink somewhere with your best friend. You're like, hey, just me. It's like we met in jail there in America.
They're all probably on death row. Do you know what I mean? Bleeding OG two times, serving back-to-back life sentences. Poor Barty. I don't know what he's doing these days. Down in Bladen Selbridge teaching kids or something. You know what I mean? Fucking teardrop tattoo.
Yeah. Stop. That's very good.
I'm telling you, Barty, see when I kick the bucket, yeah, I'm going to bunk into heaven.
Yeah, anyone's listening right now and they hate this podcast because I'm not giving you what you want, like, you got that story, that's all that matters. That's
yeah.
a great
you haven't given us work.
How have you not had an opportunity to tell? It's like, what?
I have more.
Okay,
I went to a basketball game in Green Day for free as well.
An NBA game.
You did not end an NBA game
for free
in New York in
the Garden,
just before just
Square Garden. Yeah,
no, it wasn't Madison Square Garden, it was the Barclays Center. It was in Brooklyn.
Oh yeah, okay.
Just before the pandemic. When was it? No, November or December 2019, yeah.
So did you just book a flight to America and then just fix everything over there when you got there?
Mate, I swear to good God, yeah.
Just walk into the hotel as well.
Like, yeah, just bunking anywhere. I used to bunk into Disneyland.
I fucking love... What? No.
I did.
No, he did.
Into Disneyland.
Did you ever go to Disneyland?
No, I haven't been yet, but I can imagine that.
I mean, you're about 40 and you want to go to Disneyland.
You can't turn this on me, man.
Yeah, well, hang on for a minute. If you haven't been now, it's too late. You just have to write it off.
What?
And not going.
Yeah. Ah, go away.
Until you start having nipples.
Oh,
and then
no, you're that negativity that says I'm too old to watch Nickelodeon as well. SpongeBob SquarePants.
You're too old to be on TikTok.
Oh, you know, he's coming at both of us for that one.
I don't know what he's talking about. I'm not on TikTok.
No. I've had this conversation before. TikTok is like going on a holiday with your family,
right?
You get to that age where you're too old,
right?
And then you get to that age where you're like, fuck it, I'll go. And that's TikTok. You're perfect, yeah. You're the right age for it, you're too old, and then you're perfect for it.
That little, like TikTok.
That
TikTok
little 25 to 35 age in there, you're too old for the app. Once you get 36 and start getting gray hairs, you're cute. Everyone's like, oh, he's cute. Look at that little granddad on the app. He's cute, isn't he? He's never too old for the app. He's
you're
like 50 years older than us.
You're probably about 6 months away from falling into that category, then, eh? Terrence, fella, this is how I know Terrence is too old for it. Because when Terrence gets noticed outside, it's like most people can get a pitch, I love the podcast, and that's grand. But then when kids come around, 11, 12-year-olds, you say,
TikTok.
There's Terrence from TikTok.
Yeah. There's a man off TikTok.
Yeah,
like,
but
fuck off
they, when you're doing live shows for the podcast, you know, in the Three Arena, when you guys sell it out in 2 years.
Yeah,
in 2 years, those 13, 14-year-olds are going to be 16, and they're going to be able to buy tickets to the shows. You're going to make the two of you a lot of money.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Calvin's going to do that. But yeah,
No, TikTok Terrence.
The triple T.
The triple T, mate.
See, he calls himself Terry Flow on the podcast, and I'm COB.
Yeah, I
tell him who you want. You want to be Terry O'Brien, don't you?
Yeah, Terry O'Brien.
Why?
T-O-B.
TikTok over bitches.
Yeah.
The TikTok over bitches, fella.
Yeah, do you know what I mean?
That's how we
But TikTok is good, but the ruthless, we had a little conversation.
Twitter and TikTok are
tell them what
scary
you said
places.
Again. Yeah. Tell them what you said the other day.
Your parents loving this.
Good. Okay. I'm loving it.
You're right,
I haven't slept in 4 days. I can't sleep over my head's wrecked.
Living rent-free in his head.
Oh, shit.
The comment section is. TikTok.
Yeah, but you're applying to why you're applying to
you don't understand. It breaks me fucking heart.
Man, it's a 13-year-old at home on their Nokia. Like,
yeah,
fucking,
but
they can barely watch the video. Like,
no, but you know what I mean? What did they say?
They got you
a few weeks ago.
So Calvin doesn't.
No, it only hurts when it's true. That's the thing.
Yeah, and it is true.
Oh, there we go.
It is. Right,
it hurts when it's true.
Nope,
it's
in his face.
Hold the cement on Milne walk out and the nip.
Listen. So a few weeks ago, Ternan said that people are slagging his accent because he's pointing her on.
Oh, yeah, I'll get that. That's weird.
Marty, will you do me a favor?
Well, like, you've been talking like this for the last 3 weeks. Like,
he's doing well, putting
unless
her on.
You've been putting it on for the last 3 weeks when
you're
I first met you.
But, so he said this to me, and I was like, it's probably not that bad. And then we were out the other day and literally Terrence fucking jumped. He's like, look, look, took his phone out. He's like,
oh man.
Some fella said, that's a very forced Dublin accent, Buddy Boy or something, which is a bit creepy thing to say. Like, who calls people Buddy Boy? Like, you know what I mean?
Like, forced Dublin, that's not even that offensive. You know what I mean? No, like, but you are from Dublin. Like,
no, because I'm like, what annoys you about it is, why would I force it? Oh, you hate the way I talk.
No,
like,
people do love it though. People do love it.
Tell him about the comments. What was the latest ones that
they would keep putting the H after everything. So they're writing what I'm saying, but they're saying they're forced. Shane, S-H-A-Y.
But I think, I don't want to insult you, but I think it's because of your teeth.
Absolutely not. Man, they're moving on, cut that down.
No, but you know the way...
No, but I've always spoke like this, bro, since I was a kid, because my brothers used to slag me off, because they don't talk like me.
Why are you getting slagged? It's where you're from, like, I don't get the slagging.
Yeah, because it's real, like, have you got 2 euro for a hostel type of thing?
Yeah, but I get the opposite. People assume that I'm posh.
You're posh.
What makes me posh?
With that, you say curbs.
D4 squared.
You never bump because on the Lewis.
You call it a cinema. Yeah. You put Calippos in the microwave.
So hold on a second.
You wear a buckets of dough.
Hang on, right now. Okay? Hold on, we're going to whip up.
Well, you're lost.
Hang on a minute. Right now, right?
Yeah. He's ringing the guard.
You asked us why I'm letting you get 44 reasons.
No. The definition of posh is elegant or stylishly luxurious.
Yes.
What about this is stylishly luxurious? Come on now.
We're giving it that.
No. You're having a go for the sake of having a go now.
Stylishly what?
Luxurious.
Luxurious. I can't even say
luxurious.
That.
Luxurious.
Luxurious.
You can't even say that word.
What? Luxurious.
No, oh, tell me what's stylishly luxurious about me that makes me posh. And be honest. Be serious. No jokes for the fans around here.
How
do
you sound, bro?
How I sound. Yeah, that makes me luxurious, does it?
And you're from D16.
Yeah. Wait, you don't know what my house looked like there.
You told me it's a big gaff.
I did not tell you that.
I tried to sting him now.
Yeah.
I make up a porky pie on the spot now, but it's not spent blooms now,
like
man.
You now saying that I said that Diet Coke wasn't healthy or whatever you guys said earlier.
Yeah, you did say that though.
You definitely said that.
Yeah, so I can understand when someone calls me posh, I do get angry.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
I don't reply to
it. Why'd you get angry about it?
It's the same reason why you get annoyed that people...
Would you rather be called common then?
But see, it's people just assuming something.
So you didn't say no. So we would rather be called posh.
No, look, if
no,
you
no,
want
no,
if
hang
you,
on, no, no,
Mark,
no.
If, you want to
if someone
me,
calls me posh, they're assuming something about me that they don't know. And that's what I don't like. Do you get me?
Yeah, no,
I do
get
you, but you are posh.
No, you sound posh.
Yeah. You look
that, now,
posh.
I'll stick with that. Yeah.
But you have a proper posh. Voice for the radio and all. Yeah. You know when you hear that, you're like, he's from D4.
You guys have a voice for the radio as well.
We're doing that, Bollox.
Has a face for the radio.
between tinfoil and that, they're the two now.
The Marty tinfoil.
Surely you've got better. Come on, lads.
No, bro.
I'll cut this. I'm done.
The
this
neck of us, we shouldn't be here.
No, maybe.
We're
probably
living, Marty.
Yeah. We came in here with Balaclava on, signed the deal, and here we are.
Five episodes.
I was delighted to see us. I was delighted that there was, like, I went up for the first time.
They let commoners into the building.
Well, you can get into baseball games, so fucking nobody are getting in here. Like, yeah, they didn't let you in. You snuck in. I know you did, yeah. That contract had my name on it. You guys forged it, and then fucking here you are. It worked. And it was 9:30 on a Monday, I think it was. And it's usually quiet in the building.
You remember it very well.
Walking up the steps,
and there was
serious noise going on in the canteen, and I was just like, the business needs a bit of that.
The boys,
the lads off the internet. Yeah.
We're not gonna lie, Marty. I said the second we left, you're one of the nicest people we've met since we've been to this.
I heard
building.
You say that. Yeah, that I was the only person that spoke to you, which that annoyed me.
I think we took a lot of people back though. I think because they were doing jump in this actual room. And we bounced in, screaming and shouting. Everyone's in suits and all, ready to set up.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I'm like, these cunts have laid sick of us already. You know what I mean?
We only signed the deal. Yeah.
And then Marty came in and had a chat with us. And we were like, he's all. Like,
thanks.
That's why we said we wanted to get you on.
Yeah, and here I am now.
Yeah.
Getting absolutely roasted. Fucking great.
Fuck man.
It is what it is. Johnny.
Sitting here grilling people like George Foreman.
Are we jumping back into this conversation that we were having?
No, we need to touch on the fact that you just said that you've never had a Ben & Jerry's before.
No, I've obviously had it somewhere down the line. I can't remember having it.
The mics go on. The lies come out.
I've obviously had it.
I didn't think you were like that. I didn't think you were like that.
What's
2 seconds.
Your favorite
flavor? It's the buttercup one. Peanut buttercup one. That's a rare one though. That's the annoying thing because the fish food and the cookie dough is everywhere.
Fish food's disgusting.
What's a fish food flavor? What you say now? What you say?
Oh, you really fun, man.
Fish filled.
Yeah, that's ice cream. Flavor,
yeah, they put like prawns and salmon in it.
Yeah, and the sprinkles that you give to your goldfish.
The sprinkles that you give to your
goldfish. Do you ever smell that stuff?
It's no, man.
You smell a shirt off.
Oh, run. What's your favorite one? So, that one, so good together. I think, oh, I can't remember. Wow, what's the chocolate one? What's a bit with the chocolate?
This cookie dough.
Caramel choo choo.
Caramel choo choo, yeah.
Yeah, crack, I love that.
I can't
one.
Believe you have a fucking clue what we're talking about. That's mad.
Yeah, he's lost me, boys. Oh. Yeah.
And you told me you had a manager job in.
Caught that.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
Can we just bleep that, actually?
Yeah.
See, can we bleep that, boys? Yeah, but yeah, we'll have to bleep something there. It's the Marty fella trying to hang me out the drive, boys. Yeah.
What? I didn't realise that was sensitive information.
He knew what he was doing because we blasted him over putting calipos in the mic where he's trying to get his cancelled.
Right, well, we'll jump into you, Marty.
All right, yeah.
Go on. What's your name? Where'd you come from? Yeah, well, spending about fucking an hour rambling.
Look, he's delighted. Look at him, it's me. The little blue steel into the camera.
Yeah, look at him, the Martin Guilfoyle. All
right, go on. What's first?
Right, what's your name? Where'd you come from? What was life like growing up?
Life was good, yeah. Went
hang on.
Oh, fuck.
What's your name and where'd you come from?
Oh, Martin Guilfoyle. I'm from Knockline.
Sorry to hurt.
Is outside Talla and also outside Dundrum. So depending who I'm talking to, I'll say that I'm from Talla or I'm from Dundrum.
So where are you telling us you're from then?
From Talla.
Yeah. Love that. Right. Right.
Went to St. Colum Kales, which I think we were told was like the fourth biggest primary school in Europe or something mad.
Fuck off.
Six classes of 30 kids, and apparently now they've got eight. So it's 240 kids in a year. So fifth class, sixth class, fourth class, the whole lot, yeah.
That's
nuts, yeah. And I'm still shocked that my primary school teachers will still remember my name when they see me. And I'm like, you've seen literally thousands of kids, like, yeah.
Yeah, but you're the big fella now. Yeah, yeah. You're looking for a few bob. Be clever.
But then I went to Clostana in Ballyroan, which was a change of scenery from Colum Kales. But
where's Ballyroan?
Ballyroan would be it's in between Whitechurch and Rathfarnham, so outside of Knockline. Do you know Rathfarnham?
I know
of it,
yeah.
Well, I wouldn't say I know it.
Whitechapel or Whitechurch?
Whitechurch.
Yeah. I'm bleeding bad.
Have you crossed the Liffey before, have you?
Well,
we have here, to cross the Liffey to come here. Yeah, well, here, yeah. They signed the contract. They're like, off to the south side now.
I got my passport stamped on the way over. Yeah.
So yeah, that was me growing up.
What was it like?
I'm competitive, lads. So I did well in school, but not because I wanted to be able to say I did well in school. Do you know what I mean? Which is not the reason. It's not the reason why you should do well in school.
Never walked.
No, well, see, the thing is that I'm a perfect example of how the Leaving Cert does not matter because I worked my ass off.
And you're still a waster.
Yeah. I'm still a waster. Yeah, sure. Like I'm hoping that this rejuvenates my career. Like I've jumped in with you guys, like hoping that it'll work.
No. Yeah. No, but I know what you're saying.
I went. Studied my ass over the Leaving Cert, got a good Leaving Cert, went to college to do my degree. I'm not using my degree at all.
What did you
do? Didn't need the points that I got in the end. I did business, French and Spanish and DIT. Meant to go to Trinity, but they refused me entry because I got the number of points on the button. And you go into like a random selection thing then and I didn't get picked out.
Childish.
And then I went and got history recorrected and I went up 5 points. So they were like, no, we still don't have a place for you, but we do next year. It's like, fuck that. I'm not waiting a year to go. To say I went to Trinity, not waiting a year. Fuck that. So DIT were like, oh, we'll give you a basketball scholarship. Come to us. And I was like, yeah, fuck it. And my course was business, French and Spanish. And haven't used it.
A basketball scholarship.
Yeah.
Are you good at the old basketball?
Nah, like I put it in the hoop a couple of times.
Yeah.
It's going to be, yes.
I'd say you did.
Yeah. I fucking knew you were going to say that. Yeah.
The Kobe fella. Yeah.
So yeah. That's me, and then now I'm a DJ. Yeah.
Right, we'll wrap it up and see you next week. Thanks for coming on, Marty. But what was it like growing up, Marty? Yeah, obviously you said that you were, so I'd imagine you would have been competitive then growing up.
Competitive growing up.
You just wanted to do well to say that you done better than someone else.
That's
kind
it.
Of thing.
Like my mom, all right, my mom was a senior black belt in Kempo karate. So she had me do karate from a young age. So I did karate up until I was 13, got to the black belt and was like, I don't like this, mom. She always wants me to continue it, but I went then from karate to the basketball.
Why didn't you like it?
Because it was half five every Tuesday and Thursday. And the older I got, you know, I was like, it's going to be in my friends time, and stuff. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, I was like going to karate to throw some air punches and do these mad kind of things that, like, you know, yeah. I was like, when am I going to ever use this? Like, some lad comes up to me with a knife and I'm going to go, whoa, he's not going to like stop. Oh, shit. Like, he'll probably go through me quicker. Like,
well, I think every kid should learn self-defense, though.
I get that. I do get that. But the self-defense that I learned when I was 10 years of age now won't help me now. Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, and I suppose, yeah. Well, I do get you. If you, like, if you had put a child in the mixed into martial arts now, they kind of branch off into mixed martial arts when they hit teenagers.
Which is actually beneficial. Yeah. So if you're looking at the karates, like, they're cool and they're great and your fitness and all, it's great.
Yeah.
But yeah, you look at MMA and you're like, if someone comes at you and you're training MMA, you can use that. You know? The stuff that you're doing in karate, like, yeah, you do learn some self-defense, but a lot of it is very kind of like for show and
tailored kind of.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Which is still great though. But as far as like self-defense goes for someone learning it to deal in a real life situation, I don't think it would work. Well, it wouldn't work for me anyway. So yeah, I was competitive with that, which was my mum loved. Then I got into basketball and then it just kind of took off.
Why are you going into basketball?
I was 15 when I got into basketball. And because the coach, funny enough, so I'm 6'2" now, but I was 6'2" from a very young age. And the coach saw me, like, he was like, this chap here, 13 years of age, 6'2".
He's going to be 7 foot.
After the year or two, he's like, fuck, okay, he's still 6'2". He's like, no, he's definitely going to shoot up. And like, comes to 18, oh, shit. Like, fuck, we And everyone then kind of caught up with me, like, so. But yeah, no, I loved it. Loved it, yeah.
Where do you learn to play basketball?
In Clonshane, in secondary school.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
It's a very common thing in secondary school to have to play basketball. Yeah. Very common. Not in the north side, but in the south side.
What do you play in the north side?
I've never heard of anyone.
Yeah.
Football, Gaelic, Berta Horlan, and that's it, really.
We've never played any of them. Yeah, football.
But you weren't given the option to play basketball.
In the schools.
Even Horlan is touch and go.
Yeah,
no,
Gaelic touch
and football.
Do you know what I mean? When I went to college, then someone says, hey, can you play basketball? I was like, fucking, I can play basketball if there's a session going on.
It is now in Ireland now, the basketball. Yeah, no, it is a good session, to be fair.
It is. I remember going down to Athlone.
For the varsities.
Yeah.
Yes, there we go.
First fella ever get sent off in the varsities.
What did you fucking do?
Got sent off, followed by one of the boys straight after. Because what happened?
You know it's a non-contact sport, don't you?
I know, and that's what wrecked me fucking head.
So you made up your own fucking rules.
Right, no, because this is what happened, right? Because I remember playing and one of the boys was like, see that fella there, yeah? He's going on a scholarship to America in a few months' time. And I was like, no way. And that man was fucking... What?
Do you remember his name by any chance?
No, he was fucking neat. I remember saying, he's like Paul Scholes with a basketball. But he had the ball, right? And in one hand, and he fucked it, and it spun, but the ball never bounced above your hip level, and it bounced between everyone and up perfect into this fella's hands, and he just literally lobbed it straight in, and I was like, how the fuck did you do that?
Yeah. So you knocked him out.
No, this is what happened.
So you were like,
he jumped up for the ball and he put his foot out, right? And kicked me in the hip. And I was like, what's that going on here? He said, they're kicking me. No one said anything. And I was like, all right, that's how it's going down.
And that's how you play, yeah.
So he done it again.
Fly off the top rope with a drop kick. Like that.
He done it again, right? And he kind of ran behind me. So we kind of like gave him a little elbow and he went flying. And I was like, and the ref blew the whistle. I was like, he's the fucking kicking me twice. Like, what's the story?
This is brilliant.
But then one of the fellas off his team came over and pushed me. He's like, what are you doing? And I was like, what the fuck are you doing? And then one of the boys was sitting on the bench, seeing your man push me and flew over and pushed him.
Same
and
lad,
goes, what the fuck are you doing? And said, your man flying. So I got sent off, followed by one of the boys straight after me, sent off. And I was the first person to be sent off in that, followed by one of the boys straight after.
No
so
way.
The first two. And then your man who we were fighting with, we seen him out that night and he came over and he was like, oh, lads, what happened earlier? And I was like, ah, mate, will you grow up? Someone pushed it, but you pushed it back over.
So, like, in basketball, it happens all the time. It annoys me.
I don't get how is it a non-contact sport, but, like, there's people flying in with elbows and knees and kicks and all. And then you do a
thing in basketball called a flop. And if you take a hit in basketball, you exaggerate it. A bit like a dive in football.
Yeah.
And they get called all the time and then they get the ball back and they blatantly threw themselves onto the ground. And I hate it so much. It's like when you see the footballers run around, they do it in slow motion, and you're like, nothing fucking happens.
Yeah.
You're like rolling around on your ankle, hitting the head. Like, Yeah, but they're trying to figure out like what's a flop and what's not. And especially this, some lads are like 6'8", 6'9", and some 5'11" lads giving him an elbow and he's flying onto the guy's like, come on, like it's embarrassing that you fell over, like, you know. Yeah. So
but it was good crack because the whole like there's blatant colleges from all over Ireland,
the varsities are good crack. Yeah.
Obviously went to them yourself.
We'd won in Dublin, which was a pity because we didn't get to go away for them. But then it was Cork, it was Limerick, we Galway as well. Galway, great city. Galway's great. So yeah, the varsities were definitely the best part of basketball in college. Yeah.
And then like
none of us got sent off though.
Carlo.
Oh, Carlo. Yeah.
They were in Carlo, and like everyone's fucking load of colleges in Carlo then. But the weekend,
sure, and it's only
the Foundry nightclub.
It's only one place to go. So. And the Foundry's a super club.
Yeah, it's
one of the only super clubs in Ireland.
Yeah, it's huge. Yeah, but like, guaranteed to see everyone there that night.
You know what I mean?
So that was good crack. But yeah, that was my little encounter.
That's your basketball career.
That was my basketball career. LeBron, you were calling me for that weekend.
Yeah. But I was fortunate growing up. Great parents, they hard workers. My dad's retired now and he's still working. You know, he's that kind of guy who just can't rest. You know what I mean? So they kind of got me into work. I got a job in a cafe when I was 13. I was out on my skateboard at the bottom of the road with my friends, and my mom comes running out, delighted with life. Great fucking news, Martin. And I was like, oh fuck, this is gonna be class. What is it? She's like, you got a job. And I was like, are you fucking serious? Like, I'm fucking 13. So they're like, yeah, you know, that's not great news, mum. But ended up in that cafe for 7 years as a result of it. So that was good crack. I lied about my age because I was tall. And my 14th birthday came around and everyone was celebrating my 16th birthday party until I let it slip with one of the girls that I was working with. They were like, wait, are you? And I was like, wait, who said that? I was like, fuck. Like, working
on. And were you getting paid for it and all? Yeah?
I was. Yeah, I was getting €6.50 an hour because of my age. I remember it. Doing 8 hours a week. And then I was giving 20% of it up to my parents. So I think I came out like €40 a week for the one day shift. Then they trusted me to give me an extra day. And me and my parents had this kind of agreement until I moved out that I'd give them 20% of what I was earning. So,
That's good though.
I hated them for it then, but I thanked them for it.
Yeah, growing up around people with that work ethic, you know what I mean?
My parents are mad for it. They were always, you know, pay your way, but I loved it, you know what I mean? And then whenever we were stuck as well, they were great. They helped out. So.
I don't know, you should be giving every 13-year-old a job, but no, you should be
instilling that into somebody, you know what I mean? You know, and like, even though it was £50 a week for the first year, when I was 13 to 14, and I was just literally just handing up a tenner, like, that paved the way, you know, the kind of way, it's like, you gotta pay your bills, you know?
100%.
And like, I'll always thank my parents for it, it was a great idea, so I'll be doing the same with my 10-year-old. My kid's 10. When I have a kid, as soon as you're 10, we're getting you into the radio there. Out, make coffee for Pat Kenny down there. Like.
How long did you know the basketball for then?
So up to the end of college, so to what, 22, and then I had to make a decision if I wanted to stay playing basketball or pursue DJing because you couldn't do the both.
So how did, like, so bring us to the DJing?
So DJing, I went on a Leaving Cert holiday with 6 of my friends, and it was 4 o'clock in the morning, lads. And I was in a club called 9 to 8 in Lanzarote. And there's this DJ. His name is DJ Coco Loco. He's having a great time. And I'm hammered at the back of the club, right? And I look up, and he's just having a good time. And I was like, that looks like fun. And I stroll up to him, pissed. Back then, it's like Blue Wicked, Smirnoff Ice.
How old are you back then?
I'm 18.
Right.
Leaving Cert Holiday.
Yeah, Leaving Cert Holiday. So I went up to him, and I was like, I'd love to do this. And he was like, where are you from? And I was like, Ireland. He's like, oh, I'd love an Irish barman. So he told me that if I stayed in the island that he would, you know, let me DJ. So I rang my parents and I was like, I'm not coming home. Literally, I'm going to stay here for a few months. I'm going to get a job and I want to learn how to DJ. So it started from there.
I'd imagine that didn't go down very well.
It didn't. No, you're dead right. It didn't. But now they're proper encouraging about it. So yeah.
Yeah, because you're worth a few quid. But yeah.
Best decision I ever made though. And the job that I got over there, lads, I was working 6 days a week, 10 hours a day. And I was on €3 an hour. So it was
€3 an hour.
Yeah, it is. But I loved it. Yeah. I loved it so much. You know, there was free drink in the bar all night. And if when you're over in Lanzarote, when you're there for a certain amount of time, you get like discounts and like the takeaways and stuff. Getting chicken curries and stuff for like $2.50. So while it seems like it's not a lot of money, you don't need any more over there.
Yeah,
you know? What do you need money for? Like the sun shining every day, you're by the ocean. It's like, you don't need money. You know
it's the nice things.
Yeah, so... yeah, loved it. All started from there. Came home, thought I was Calvin Harris. And yeah, that's where it started.
You changed the name from Martin to Marty then?
I changed from Martin to Marty to kind of match like an artist thing, because it sounds ridiculous, but there's a Martin Garrix and we were like, oh fuck, another Martin G, like nah, we'll go with Marty, we'll just go with Marty. And now everyone in Ireland makes a joke, Marty Morrissey.
So the DJing thing, you come back to Ireland.
Come back to Ireland. And I ring up a local radio station and I'm like, hey.
What, you just rang them?
Rang them. Fucking rang them. Based in Lucan. Liffey Sound FM. I'd say they had about 10 listeners a day. Because it's a community radio station. And a guy called Fran picks up the phone. Fran Walsh. And I'm like, my name's Martin. I want to be on the radio. And he was like, you can't just fucking ring a radio station and say I want to be on it. And you're like, but you know what? I like it. Come on down. And back then I was driving a Fiat Cinquecento. You know Cinquecento?
No. Yeah. The in-betweeners car.
The in-betweeners car. Perth, that's the best way to describe it. Yeah. It's like a washing machine on wheels.
Yeah.
So I hopped in it, all right? So it's an 800cc, not even a 1 litre. And I'm bombing it down the M50 because I'm like, I'm on the fucking radio. And I went in and he just put
me on. That's not even allowed on the M50.
Wait, isn't it?
I don't think so. No.
What? Yeah, under a 1 litre.
I was pursuing my dreams. I could have told the guards they would have got it. It's fine.
Yeah.
Wait, isn't that if you chicken chendo not letting the motorway?
Well, we wouldn't let it on the motorway.
Oh yeah, that's fair enough. Now, like I was fucking dangerous and there's no airbags or anything. Like, but brought me in and gave me a show because he was like, love your confidence. Did the show for a couple of years, thought I was the business, sent a demo to Spin. A guy called James Davis got back to me and said, look, this is shit. But we hear potential. And brought me in. And I started working with Spinny and then I'm with Spin now nearly 11 years. So,
and the rest is history.
That's it, yeah. Just put myself out there and said, fuck it.
Yeah, right. Fran, thought I was,
Fran thought I was a cocky shit when he picked up the phone. He was like, you can't just fucking ring someone. But I was like, if he didn't make that phone call, like, you know.
Yeah.
How would he find you?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's it, yeah. So.
And we heard some big news for you recently.
Oh, go on.
About no, not even that one. Listen, you're getting a bit of stick over the other one now in a minute.
Oh, shit.
But
here we go.
you signed the new deal.
Did, yeah.
Fill us in.
Yeah.
The few quid fella gives a land.
He's still giving it 20%.
Every second sentence now is like, what, how much?
Yeah, fuck, give us a whole door on TikTok, will you?
Yeah, no. So you guys are talking about the Christmas party here. I'm thinking of a Sony Christmas party. I'm like, I'm going to go up to Little Mix and I'm going to be like, hey.
Don't be slaving, boss. Little Mix
at the Christmas party. Imagine Little Mix without our Christmas party. Straight up to the window.
If you go for the mixing, all right?
Just walk up, margin the weekend.
Fuck. Yeah, so, signed a long-term deal with Sony UK. They've got like a sub-label called Relentless. So first track is out August 3rd. So. There's a cheeky plug. Guys.
There we are. Now. That's next week. Can't wait for the listening party.
Yeah, the
listmas party.
All right, now what's the next thing? I'm scared here now. What's going on here?
Well, there's a couple of things.
Oh, man.
Right, so hang on, Marty. Obviously,
I've made some poor decisions.
I've made some very poor decisions.
Yeah.
So you jumped on with Spin. You would have been young, what, early 20s?
Spin.
Yeah.
Yeah. Starting out in my 20s,
Early 20s, and that you were trying to get the feel for the industry. So you had to put yourself out there.
You had to say yes to a couple of things, man. Yeah, that's it.
Like, take me out,
yeah.
Yeah. So tell us about that.
You walk out in front of 30 girls and you try to get a date.
How'd you get into that, though? What made you think, like, you know what, that sounds like a great idea?
No, really, though.
So I used to work with a modeling agency when I was younger, and they got a call from the producer to take me out, and they were like, the girls are picky as fuck. Any chance we could use some of the lads? I was like, oh, that's a terrible idea. Like, they're going to fucking hate. If someone walks out and they're like, I'm a model. Like, they're going to fucking think, no, I don't want to see this guy. He's clearly a prick. Like,
yeah.
That is a prick.
And I was like, no, I'm not fucking doing that. No way. And I put up a tweet back when Twitter was fun. And I put up a tweet and I was like, oh, take me out, just called. Not a fucking chance am I doing that. I get a message off my friend Maeve. She was like, oh, I saw your tweet. Please come on it. And I was like, what do you mean, please come on it? She was like, I'm one of the girls on it. Like, I'm fucking, they're not giving us guys that I want to go out with. So if you come on it, I'll leave my light on for you, and then you're guaranteed a date.
No, so it was a setup.
Set up the whole thing.
You dirty bastard. Set up the whole thing. Really don't know.
And I don't mind talking about it now because that was TV3 and it's Virgin Media now. So it's grand. Like, you know, TV3 doesn't exist.
Yeah.
So I had to go out there, and then it got to a point, lads, and you'll get where I'm coming from here, where other people left their light on as well. And I was like, oh, hang on a minute. Like, do I have to pick her?
Imagine
hanging her out to dry. But I was like, nah. I was like, can't do that. Like, that would have been terrible. But
how would it have been terrible? You have to think.
You
need to be thinking downstairs, not upstairs. In
Situation. Yeah, bro. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, and we watched it. It's
so
cringy.
It's so cringe. Yeah,
but we had to give credit where it's due, mate. You walked out. You said, what's the story? I said, Martin. And not one light went off. 40 lights, bro.
But then that was the point where I'm looking at them and I'm going,
Well, have a choice.
I have a choice. Yeah, because I was like, the whole idea was is that I didn't think that I was going to have another light on, but I was guaranteed her light. I was like, we're guaranteed someone.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden I'm like, oh, fuck, do I have to pick Maeve now? Yeah. Like, you know what I mean? Like, yeah. So...
could be
well, you were right as well, because when you say on it, because we only watched it yesterday, when you say on it, you're a model. Boom, 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 boom,
boom, boom. I lost 8, 9, 10, just with the model.
12 you lost, I remember. Yeah.
But who's counting?
And but then we had to go on a date afterwards, and that was for the next episode. So we had to fucking pretend like we didn't know each other. Yeah. You know what I mean? So she was like, oh, where are you from? And I was like, Knockline. And she was like, fuck, I am too. And I was like, no way. Like, yeah. We fucking know each other. Like,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, that's what
but
happened.
But don't just skip past the modeling bit either.
But hang on, we have to talk about the bleeding to take me out. The jeans you had on swinging off you, Marty. What's the story with that?
Like, fuck me.
They were some pair of baked beans on you.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh,
my God. What were you, 48 waist?
If I could change. So, funny you mention that. I still do that to this day. I still buy jeans that are bigger for me and wear a belt. I don't know why.
Childish, yeah.
It is, yeah.
Why would you not just buy something that fits you?
Yeah, you know what I mean?
Do you know what makes...
You're a grown man, like,
sure, I'm the guy who puts the clip on the fucking microwave.
Yeah. Hard wears, Hawaiian shorts and the baggy jeans. I got it. And he's got
the I was a skater growing up. I was a skater guy. So, like, the baggy jeans was part of it.
Oh,
I just,
yeah. Remember that bit of skates?
Oh, no. Yeah. I went through a phase having that chain running around the side of me thinking, oh, fuck, what's it?
Looking wearing Vans and all.
Wearing the Vans.
Dirty Vans at that as well.
Well, sure. Like, back then, like, I was only working 6 hours a week, so I couldn't be getting new Vans.
Well, you wouldn't
week.
Be doing it now.
You could still wipe your Vans.
Oh, you wipe. Sorry, but those wipes are expensive. Like,
mate, it's a face cloth out of gaff.
Yeah, but then I want to buy my clip. I'll sweat, man. So yeah, the baggy jeans, jeez, I think I still had them from when I was skating, thinking they covered up what I was wearing, it'd be fine. And then all of a sudden I look back now and think, what the fuck?
Yeah, and this was only about 2 years ago as
it
well.
It was not 2 years ago. Oh, no, like,
what year was his, man?
So the funny thing is when they recorded it, it was the last episode of the last season. And then they put it all out like over the course of 2-3 years. So like my age in it wasn't the age that I was, but they put the age that I was at the time it went out on the age of me two years beforehand. A lot happens between 21 and 23,
so,
lads.
Say you were recorded that at 20, and then when it came out, you were 22.
And I was like, hang on a minute. Whoa.
You know? I'm not 22.
A lot happened. Yeah. Those years, so much fucking happens over those years. Like, you discover a pair of skinny jeans.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Like, you decide the spiky hair doesn't fucking work. Like,
yeah, you got a skin fade.
As a skin fade, yeah.
You stop skating like a fool.
Stop skating like a fool.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Take up TikTok, you know what I mean? Like, So that pissed me off a little bit. But that's why I'm like, I don't mind telling the story now. I'm like, yeah, it's grand. Like,
ah, listen, it's gone. A bit of crack. It's something to look back on, isn't it?
Yeah, that's it.
So, for the modelling thing, how the fuck do you go modelling in France?
Oh, so France. So part of my study abroad thing was to go live in France for a year. So I moved to Lyon.
Did you do an Erasmus?
Did Erasmus play basketball over there?
How do you always know this shit? What does that mean, man?
Erasmus, man, is you do a course and they send you away for a year because they don't want to look at you. And then you go over there and you fuck all. And you come back and you have to tell people you studied abroad.
Is that what you did in America?
No, that's not. I done a J1 in America. Did you ever do a J1?
I didn't do a J1. No, but they're the same. Oh, no, J1. They're not completely different. J1. You just go over the summer and get pissed. Like.
It's literally, I couldn't, anyone that's in college, now, probably now with the pandemic, but just go to college to do a J1.
Yeah,
Honestly, it's, I don't understand how it's allowed. It should be illegal. They literally take a gang of fucking head cases from Ireland, put them in America, and all the Irish communities just stay together anyways. And it's just a whole summer of going on the rip.
But
that's all it is.
People are doing that in the Erasmus too. So I try to get away from that because everyone was going on Erasmus to France, Lyon, and they were looking for the English and Irish people. And I was like, fuck that. Like, I'm here in France. Like, I want to hang out with the French people and learn fucking French. Like, so went to France for the year. Where was I going with that? Fuck. Oh, the modeling. And I was already working with modeling agencies in Ireland, which is like that they call themselves that. But like, no, I won't get into that. But, and I was like, fuck it. If I'm a model in inverted commas, which I fucking wasn't in Ireland, fuck it. I could probably do it in France. And some agency in Paris were like, yeah, we'd love to have you. And I was like, sorry, what? So
what were you doing here then if you weren't, like, if you think you were
so
modeling?
like modeling in Ireland back then, like there was no like fashion shows or anything. Like it was.
You might get your pitch on in the windows and pennies.
Nailed it. Fucking nailed it. So you were with a modeling agency, but like another job I got out of it was like I stood at the door of Abercrombie when it opened up and said hi to people. And Abercrombie were calling them models. And I was like, we're not fucking models. Like, there's people saying hello to people. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But over in France, though, fuck me. Different ball game altogether.
Blue Steel over there.
Oh, no. But I was shit over there. Like
catwalking on.
Oh, stop, man. So I went, met with the agency in Paris. They're called Adole. Lovely. Got pictures taken, the whole lot.
put me on the website and they were like, Paris Fashion Week's coming up. We're going to send you to all these castings. And I'm like, are you fucking serious? Paris fucking Fashion Week. They're sending me to like Dior, Jean Paul Gaultier, all these fucking designer brands. Mm. And I have to walk in front of these people. And not one of them said yes to me. Mm. Do you know how shit it is to go to a bunch of people for a whole day, walk in front of them, and they all say no to you?
Everyone says you're stinking gorilla.
Oh, I was, okay, so I was 30 pounds lighter then. And they were still saying that I was too broad. They wanted lads that were like fucking twigs, like, you know what I mean? So they were getting all the Scandinavian guys and stuff to walk in all their shows. And I was like, at the end of the day, I was like, what the fuck am I doing here? Do you know what I mean? But I got a couple of jobs out of it. One job I got with a magazine, ended up in the back garden of some studio, got a bucket of water thrown over my head, wearing some fucking leather top. I don't know what it was. An experienced lad, we'll call it.
Yeah.
In the middle of fucking November.
Sounds like a scene out of Finland Bruno, but how whatever.
Broadback Mountain.
So, I got a good few jobs out of it now, to be fair. And like, when I was doing that with Chinese deliveries and the cafe and stuff, like, and I wanted to be a DJ on the side, it kind of made sense to just have those
50 jobs.
50 jobs. Yeah. And then when you can finally go, fuck it, I think I'm getting enough out of the one job I want, just give it all up. And it was fucking scary, you know, leaving the Chinese deliveries, leaving the cafe, the whole lot, and going, nah, I'm going to be a DJ full time. And I'm fortunate enough now that it's kind of worked out. So.
Yeah.
Class.
So you're doing 10 spin hits in a row. What's a leading spin, summer house mix? Yeah. All
Marty running a fucking mug. Legend of a man.
But I know I gave you a bit of stick about this at the start, but like fucking TikTok has been.
Oh, stop.
It's a been different a launch pad, mate, isn't it?
Do you get opportunities from TikTok?
I genuinely mean this. So, like I said, I had that one video that got 25 million views, 5 million likes, and I was getting
that's ridiculous.
Places all over the world saying, come DJ for us. That was great. And then I had one TikTok where a mashup I made got used by over 150,000 people. And that ended up on the radar of all the major labels. So without TikTok. Now,
is that how Sony got you then?
So the thing is that like anyone I say this to, they tell you, like, shut up, man, you've worked hard, you deserve it. And I'm like, well, hang on. Like, no, like, as in, part of it is luck, you know? And like,
well, a part of everything is luck, man. It's not like as if everybody just walks out.
Yeah, that's what I was going to fucking say. Life. And like, I think that if you turn around to somebody and you say, work hard and you'll get there, you're bullshitting them because it doesn't happen to everybody.
Of course,
you
need a bit of luck.
You need a bit of luck, yeah. So I feel like doing the mashups on TikTok got the attention of the big labels. And from last September, I got so fortunate that they were all like
lining up.
I was like, what the fuck is going on here, lads? And it was all because of TikTok, you know? Without TikTok, like, yeah, maybe down the line we would have got a hit or something that maybe did well. But the fact that we were causing a muck on TikTok was like, they were like, yeah, fucking, who's this guy? He's doing all this on TikTok. What's he like in his live shows? And they went back over videos and stuff. And oh, without TikTok, like, it just, I don't think it would have happened.
Because you were doing festivals and all, weren't you?
Oh, like, all the festivals, every nightclub in Ireland, like, I was on the road doing 4 or 5 nights a week along with the radio show, and I loved it. But they don't see that, you know? Like, they're not at those gigs.
Yeah.
But I still love those gigs. But when a TikTok pops up on the right person's For You page, like, if someone here is listening, they're like, I want to do radio, I want to do anything, like, get on fucking TikTok. Yeah. That For You page, you could have been on Ariana Grande's For You page there recently. You just don't fucking know.
Yeah.
You know
what I mean? That
imagine Ariana Grande open up her phone and they see
you. There's Terry Flower. Yeah, yeah. Don't need quit. We'll whispers where nothing's in our ear.
But that's the fucking thing, though, you know? That's the thing. So I ended up obviously on someone's radar because of it, and there we go. Yeah.
What's the most downloaded app in 2020?
Fuck off, is it? There you go.
That's a bit of crack there, isn't
it? Yeah. I was looking now that I got on the buzz before the pandemic hit, so I kind of already had an audience there.
Head start.
People just got addicted to it then, didn't they, over the last year?
Nothing else to do.
Yeah, nothing else to do.
Sitting in the gap watching TikTok. Yeah. But I suppose with that comes the negative, doesn't it, Marty?
Oh, stop, yeah.
Fuck. You didn't hear you're getting off at this one. We have to go into it now.
Go
Marty.
On.
Come on.
Hit me.
What was it called? The goat gaff?
Yeah, the goat gaff. It would have been better being called that, yeah.
What was it? It's the goat house?
The goat house,
that's the goat gaff,
yeah. We changed it to the goat gaff.
What do you call it? A quick one there for you as well. Because you're not that. bastard. A dressing gown or a morning coat? Or a house coat?
A dressing gown.
See what I mean? And we knew that as well. That was one that we forgot to ask. Yeah, the house coat.
I thought you were agreeing with me for a minute. I was like, fuck.
Never.
Gaff jacket all day.
A gaff jacket
all day.
So, the goat gaff.
Yeah, one tweet just fucking ruined the whole thing.
So what was that all about, Mike? Because I remember this was in like height of pandemic, like lockdowns, wasn't it? Because I remember.
No, well, it wasn't in the height of it now. We were just out of one. and we were like leaning towards a new one. And people were still kind of, it's a bit like being able to travel this week. People are like, I can go, but am I going to go? Because there's always going to be someone who's going to go, no, you shouldn't be doing that. But I feel like that we've all done so much over the last year and a half. There's always going to be someone who's going to go, you shouldn't be fucking doing that. You're like, well, why not? Like, I got to live my life as well. You know what I mean? Yeah. So
you can't fucking play.
It was in September, and I can't remember what the guidelines and all were, but that wasn't the issue. I think the issue was is that people in Ireland didn't understand the idea, because we're fed Big Brother and we're fed Love Island. We're fed all these reality TV shows, and they just assumed it was one of those. So people just assumed it was like a dating show or something. And I was like, no, it's 10 people who have big audiences just living in the same house and combining it for one massive audience. Do you know what I mean?
How did the idea come about? How did
I got a voice note from the guys running it. And they didn't even tell me who was going to be in it. They were like, look, this is the number of followers you have. You'd actually have the smallest number of followers compared to everyone else.
And I was thinking,
hang on a minute. Like this is before now that I've got my record deal and shit. I'm like, I fucking want a record deal. I'm like, if my music gets used in their TikToks, like fucking who knows who'll hear it then, you know? That's all my head's thinking. I'm like, fucking, let's go.
And then
it gets announced and one girl decides to tweet. She hears that there's a couple of people in the house that are 19, teenagers. And she tweets, isn't that just predatory?
That Marty
Guilfoyle is living with a bunch of teenage girls. And people read that tweet and kind of piled on that without doing the research on what it actually was. Mm. Next thing you know, I'm trending in Ireland ahead of the coronavirus, which is fucking mad. My mom sees it, doesn't know what it's for, thinking my song is doing well, clicks into it and sees all this shit. And I was like, oh, fuck. Because I didn't mind it. Like, well, obviously, there's a part of me that was thinking, look, it's a bit shit because if you can't handle that, that could really get to someone.
Yeah. Fucking, right?
Yeah. Like, you know, especially your accent, like, for example. Like, you lost sleep over.
I actually don't really lose sleep over.
No, I'm joking.
It's a funny thing, you know what I mean? But I mean, like, that's cancel culture on a nutshell, isn't
it? That was it. But again, I don't think that it would have been as big a deal if we weren't in the middle of a global pandemic. I think that people were already kind of, people are bored, they're frustrated, they're latching onto any news.
Yeah,
do
you think they are just moving the crosshairs onto the next thing?
But the funny thing is that it was said to me, it was like, I kind of came off social media for a couple of days before throwing out like a statement and shit. And people were like saying this to me, they're like, this is going to blow over. And in the middle of it, you don't fucking think it's going to. But it did.
Yeah.
Because then they found someone else to fucking attack, you know, the kind of way. So
what happened then? Like, it just all kind of collapsed on itself, did it? That
idea is still going. They've actually moved it now to LA. So the same guys who ran the one here in Dublin have moved it to LA. So it's still going. It's a huge thing in the UK and America. Like, it's a massive thing.
So again, Ireland was trying to copy that.
Yeah, but as in good Ireland fashion, we don't copy American and English entertainment very well, do we? Like,
no.
And when we tried to do it, the public, we get torn apart.
I think Ireland's a country full of begrudgers.
Yeah.
Unless, because that was only starting in Ireland, yet, and it was a new thing. If this was like, how do I explain it? Like, if it was already ready-made, because people in Ireland love to jump on the bandwagon.
Yeah.
You get me? So when something's going well, everyone's like, God, that's lethal, that is. And then eventually you'll get cunts trying to pull you down.
Yeah.
But I mean, when something's only starting and nobody can see the bigger picture or the idea, it's full of begrudgers.
And especially given the kind of manner where it's like, they're moving everyone into Donnybrook, into this big mansion. It just
moved them into the flats.
But I mean, like, if they had turned to me and said, well, I wouldn't care. All I could think about was this big fucking I didn't see the house until I went there with my fucking suitcase.
Yeah.
Swear to God. I was like, this is the first time.
Oh my God, that's what you even explained yourself for. You what did, right?
No, yeah, no. Yeah. You know, I'm sorry. I mean, yeah, I'm getting worked up here now.
Relax, man. Give him a cup of coffee. Yeah. Oh, fuck, shit.
So, no, where I come from, where like, we don't copy them very well. And all that they was like, look at fucking California, even Take Me Out. That, like, look back at Take Me Out compared to the English one.
Oh, stop. They got to go to what, Ibiza, was it? Mallorca? We went to like the fucking the classroom in the back of DCU Helix where they set up a little table and stuff. Like but then again, like money and budgets and all have to play a part too. But I think we love though as a country, like if we see someone in Ireland trying to do something that's already established in America, we love to be negative from the get-go.
Yeah.
Isn't it? From the start.
Critical
we're like
off the bus.
Straight off.
Just comparing.
Yeah.
Everything.
Yeah.
But whereas
if you were to get somebody who hasn't seen the other two and then sit down and watch the Irish one, they'd probably really enjoy it, like, because they don't know any better. You know what I mean?
It wouldn't be my cup of tea.
No. But
I wouldn't be going out.
But I think it's more ground for us then to like get some originality into it. You know what I mean? Like, do your own thing, branch off. Like, I'm trying to think of a good example. Like, look at Love Hate. Love Hate was never done in Ireland, and we didn't copy off anything. Love Hate was fucking quality. It was absolute quality.
Where is it though? Where is it? We haven't had it since. Like, where is it gone?
That's basically where we got Barry Keoghan from. You know what I mean?
No, what I mean is like we didn't copy off anything else.
Yeah, I know.
We didn't like even look at The In-Betweeners. The In-Betweeners is absolute comedy gold, A1 telly, and then they copied that in America and it fell flat in its face.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? I just think you should be doing something that you build up from the ground, originality, and go with that. Don't try and copy something that's ready-made because you're never going to be able to copy
I think the initial kind of idea is that, well, it was successful there, so we can make it. But like, I think in Ireland, we've learned that that's not always the case.
It doesn't work.
No,
doesn't
but like,
work.
You nailed it with Love Hate. Yeah, like you said, it was built from, and everyone could relate to it. That was
deadly.
Because you felt like that when you went outside after watching an episode of Love Hate, that you were in it. You know what I mean? Like, you heard the accents.
Looking over your shoulder.
You saw the pubs. Yeah, yeah.
When you're sitting at the traffic lights and a fella pulls up to you on a bike, you think about breaking the light. You think about breaking the light.
And then you listen to Nidge talk in real life and you're like, fuck, he's a great actor.
It's like me and you, isn't it?
Maybe you are putting that accent on. Nidge did it for the whole fucking series. Yeah.
And he's doing about every episode of the podcast.
Yeah. No, bet that, man.
Yeah.
But, Marty, like, what, like, going back to it, what advice would you give to someone? Look, how are you so happy all the time? Like, every time you see
because,
you,
Because, Mark, it is
happy.
A big thing to
but
bounce
that
back
is,
from.
That's huge, man.
It's as if, Marty's done it. They're big accusations to bounce back from.
Well, of course, with no proof, it was never going to be something where you get cancelled, right?
Yeah.
Of the stupid shit.
Because it was all lies.
Yeah,
and it wasn't even accusations. It was just throwaway words.
Yeah,
so,
but
still
must they're
be
heavy.
Hard to hear, though.
You know what? I'll be honest, lads. I was more worried about my mom. Imagine being a parent and going on a social media and seeing all these people say this stuff about your kid.
Your child, yeah.
And you know him better than anybody.
Yeah.
You know, and then that was my worry. My mum was constantly, I love her for it, constantly checking in, you sure you're okay? And like, trust me, I'm fine. It's like, because I've been through it, lads, like, more than people know. Because back in the day when you were working on radio and there wasn't like fucking these mad cancel culture people coming at you, like, people used to send texts into the station and you'd get it direct.
Yeah.
You know, I'm down in Waterford, like working for Beat 102, 103, and someone would send a text message in there like, what is this fucking shite? Go back to Dublin. And I'm like, well, first of all, it's great. He recognized them from Dublin. Cheers. Yeah. Like, yeah. And then, but you're reading that. That's been sent direct to you. When someone puts up a tweet about you, it's kind of like, you know, you might not see it, you might see it.
It's kind of for our audience.
Yeah. And the thing is, I've always said to people, it's like, if you take someone puts up a tweet about you, all right, or a comment on TikTok or anything, back in the day, all right, back in the 90s, if they wanted to get that message to you, they had to write it down on a letter, get a stamp, put it into the envelope, put the stamp on the envelope, and they had to post it. Because there was no other way of contacting you.
Yeah.
And they wouldn't fucking do that.
No.
And if you go in your head, right, would they write this down on a piece of paper and post it to me? 9 out of 10 times, the answer is no. Then it means
so you've built this up over the years from being young and radio.
But it's just because it's so easy for someone to leave a comment.
They're throwaway comments.
Yeah. They're throwaway, yeah. And people are trying to like come up with the better comments, get more likes and stuff. Yeah. They don't even mean what they're saying, you know?
But I don't think there's enough people outside of them comments that look at that. Like, as if, say, like, if Terrence put up a throwaway comment about you, I don't think there's enough people who have that attitude that you have to look at it and be like, well, that comment actually doesn't mean anything.
Okay.
They kind of pick what he says as gospel and go with it.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, if you could instill that mentality on people and be like, actually, it's so easy for me to fucking type 280 characters onto Twitter about Marty Guilfoyle, hit, tweet, and boom.
Yeah. And if you read that tweet and you go, fuck it, would they take the time to post that in a letter? And then, no, they wouldn't. Because they don't care.
It's good mindset,
they probably don't even know who you are. They probably read about you off someone else's Twitter. They don't even know what you look like. You know what I mean? Like, so. Mm. And they're always, on Twitter, they're always on an egg account. Like, they don't have a profile picture.
Yeah, Twitter's good crack, though.
Oh, but people coming at me, calling me a cringe.
It is dangerous.
I'm with you, it is. Like, I do have my certain things that I search. But on TikTok, what pisses me off is people are still commenting these things on my videos to this day. And they've got no followers and no profile picture. And they're calling me the creep. And I'm
that's scary.
Yeah, you're on the app watching videos off an account 100%. That we don't know who you are.
Yeah, that's scary, man.
I'm the fucking creep.
Yeah.
Super personal. Do you guys have an online gambling account? An online betting account?
No.
I used to, yeah.
Okay, I used to as well. So what was the one thing you had to do?
Before
you would draw your money, every Boyle Sports, Paddy Power, Bet365, you fucking name it, they've got millions of customers. The only way they'll give you the money you win is by verifying a utility bill and a passport. It's why can't the social media sites do that?
But we said this the other week and then someone actually gave us a valid argument to that, and it was that Facebook leaked 500 million. Am I right, China?
Yeah, data, yeah. Data.
People's
500
data.
500 million accounts were breached. The data was breached.
And but that's why, like... It's a decent argument towards it. I still think that you should have to verify your account because of the racism that's going on, which is way too serious.
Yeah.
Well, and then that should be optional then. Well, listen, it's up to you if you want to verify your account to go on. But you don't have to go on.
If you don't, yeah. if you don't want to verify your account, you can't come on.
If it's
going to
stop racism on social media... And you're concerned about the data breach, but just don't go on it. I'll go on it and I'll enjoy the no racism on it.
Even the no racism part, it's the fact that if someone says Marty Guilfoyle's a prick, you can look at him and be like, oh, that's actually Calvin O'Brien and he's this. Oh, I know who that, like, not that I know him personally, but like, I know who.
I'm knocking on his door with a baseball bat. I let down nixers on people.
Then I'm fucking trending for assaulting him. That's fucking true, I would have taken anything else over what I fucking got.
No one else would be tweeting about you again.
No, that's actually very true. Anything else I would have fucking taken over what it was. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Well, no, like, it's weird because somebody fucking tweeted something I put up the other day. They ran away with it. I was clearly being sarcastic. And quote tweeted me, and I just commented on that. Mate, make sure you quote tweet me again. I'm loving your tears off this saltiness. Do you know what I mean?
Absolutely grand.
But me and him had a bit of a back and forth, and we ended up fucking having a conversation. I was like, you know what, mate? I thought you were going to be a prick. You're actually grand. And he said the same thing to me. I had a bit of laugh with him. You know what I mean? Like, human side. The proof is in the button. Your man was snapping.
I think the best thing you can do sometimes, I think, is just not interact with them. Maybe one every so often. And if you hit one every so often, it annoys the others because you're like, oh, fuck, wait, why? He didn't get back to me. It actually annoys them more when you don't reply to them.
Yeah, I used to be a cunt for that. I don't engage with anyone.
No, but they want you to see. They want you to talk to them. That's the funny thing. Yeah. You know, the kind of way. So
It's like that tattle thing, right? You know, tattle.
Stop. I've stayed off
that. If we keep mentioning this, we're definitely going to appear on it.
But you guys are doing really well. You know, you're with us now and you've got a great podcast, great personality.
Awesome,
but the more that you're going to fucking get way more of it. Like,
we don't care.
That came around looking for a picture on his bike with you, the next lad's going to come around calling you a fucking dickhead. Like,
he'd want to be good old bloke.
One lad will be wanting a picture, the other lad will be calling you a dickhead.
It's bound to come. Like I said a minute ago, look, Ireland is full of begrudges. But then again, bandwagoners as well. So when something's going well, everyone's on board.
There is
a point in time when everyone's going to go, actually, these are cunts.
Yeah.
It'll drop off a little bit and then it'll grow.
And it's going to down to you then to carry it. But what you were saying, like someone's calling you a creep, but like they're hiding behind the account. That's what we were saying about that. Like, are you not worried about yourself? You don't know who you're actually talking to, but you're coming together and uniting to talk about somebody and you're like, this is...
Imagine falling in love with somebody and realizing they do that in their spare time.
Oh, I'm actually worried about that. Them people need to be assessed.
I actually would love I'd love to just go, look, are you all right?
Yeah.
You know I mean, need a hug, it's...
Some people just need that.
Yeah, no, I do
get it. Look, I can't get a minute to myself, And these cunts have all day to just write down
and eat the back off
on anonymous accounts about, influences and stuff like that. You know what I mean? That's mad.
And touching back to what you're saying about people on the bike, some people need to realise not all these people you see online who have an online persona are friendly. Like Terrence, if you get smart with the wrong person, you will get a clatter.
I can't show hands, bro. Put the hands up.
I was saying before, people have knocked around my house looking for photos. That's fine. Like, I'm not, at the end of the day, they're young, they're teenagers. Like, I'm not scared of them. But like you said, you're right, you know? You can't just assume that the person that you watch on your phone every day as well is going to welcome you into their
and they owe you something like, oh, you owe me a picture. Yeah, you get a clap if you come to your name and I'm with you. How straight. Yeah, someone comes to me and I'm sitting there with half
it's a bully mentality though, you know what I mean? For some of them, I think a lot of them have a bully mentality where, like, even if they think the same of two influencers, but they know one influencer can fight and they'll see one going past, they go, oh, what's up, Marty? Say, but then they see the other one who they also hate. And they see it going past, but they, like, say for the looks of Keeper Crosby was an influencer, or some MMA fighter like that. They never do that. They never go, oh, there's Keeper, watch it. Right. You know what I mean? Yeah. With the attitude.
Yeah.
So they pick and choose who they want to say things because they know someone will get
the DJ
slap.
With the fucking shit shirts.
You know what I mean? Yeah. And that's what people assume, he has the posh accent, he puts calipos in the microwave and he's a DJ. There's Marty. But they'll pick and choose. You know what I mean? Because someone got a smack of a bottle of Heineken in the face. Hit the boys.
Heineken zero now if you're driving, right?
Yes. Yeah. On the ball. Right, Matt, what's your plans for the future?
Yeah.
Fuck, I don't know. So,
are you playing picnic this year?
Oh, that's such a hard question to answer.
He knows and he doesn't want to be there.
Yeah. I haven't been told. Obviously, it's been moved. Like, fuck, we want it to happen, don't we? And why wouldn't it? Like, we're fucking getting vaccinated. We're all doing our bit. Oh.
That's not going to end well.
Oh, shit, yeah. if it's on, like, I'll be at it. Definitely, yeah. I can't see why not. As far as the future goes, like, with the new deal with Sony, like, this is going to sound real cheesy, but, like, I'm in a great relationship. I'm mad about my girlfriend, and she's got a good job going for her, and she's worked hard to get there, and I just kind of want to get back out and see the world. Like, yeah. You've been fucking stuck at home for a year and a half,
man,
lads. You know what I mean? Like,
that, mate.
So, yeah. So
you're playing in Hakkasan next year is what you're telling
us. Oh, stop. The dream, isn't it? Yeah. All right, Calvin, what's happening? Tiesto, yeah. Pal, been a while, you know? Yeah. Quick story about Tiesto, because I have to tell this, but now that you've mentioned Hakkasan.
Hang on for a second. Oh. It's in Las Vegas. Big nightclub in Las Vegas.
Oh, yeah.
I thought it's Pakistan. I was like, that must be a good spot over there. Like, electric picnic. What am I on the map? Do you not say Pakistan, bro? No.
Oh, shit.
Right, Melbourne. No, where's your Colorado?
Nevada.
Pop
it up.
No. Go on. A song we made years ago, all right? A Dutch DJ called Don Diablo played in his radio show, and Tiesto's producer heard it, okay? And he got on to me, and he was like, hey, Marty, I've got a client called Tidge. Tidge is Tiesto's real name. Tiesto, like fucking Tiesto. And he was like,
Tidge, Nidge's cousin.
Tidge and Nidge, yeah. Nidge. I wonder.
That's your deal. You're
me,
Nidge,
we're Tidge and Nidge, yeah.
You're Nidge. I'm Tidge.
And, I was like, nah, look, he was like, my client's looking for his radio show. His name is Tidge. And I was like, look, sorry, the track's not out yet. Right? Yeah. I was like, but when it is out, I'll make sure that I'll get it onto you. He gave it to Don as like an official premiere. And he was like, no problem. Thanks for that. When it's out, let us know. And I got back into the group of the lads. And one of the guys who made the song, it was Dutch, and his name was Sheng. And then I had my fucking music husband, Connor. And I was like, lads, fucking people are loving this song. Some lad called Tidge wants to play in his radio show. And Sheng, being from Holland, Tiesto's from Holland as well, he was like, Tidge? ? And I was like, yeah. He goes, that's fucking Tiesto. Send him the fucking song, man. I was like, got back straight away. I was like, hey, just spoke with the lads. No, Tidge, absolutely. He can do whatever the fuck he wants with it. Yeah, he can play it as much as he wants. Like, next thing a week later, pops up, we're getting tagged in fucking Tiesto's club life. I was like, nearly fucking ruined that one. Like, that trying to be all cool. Some tiny fucking DJ in Ireland going, no. Have to wait till it's out, Tidge. You know what I mean?
But, yeah.
So, yeah.
So, Vegas residency
we'll see.
On the
new
cards.
Track out August 3rd. Well, it's not new. It was out already, but it's a re-release.
Yeah.
And then I've got a remix for that done. That'll be out 2 weeks after that. So.
And then you're getting Marty to the missus is what you're telling me.
That's fucking cheesy. I've never said that on a podcast before. Yeah. Of all the podcasts to pick.
Come on, look, we love an exclusive.
Look, being honest, lads, she's fucking great.
And
she's
yeah,
done
look
so
at,
much.
American's a good crack. I'd say it's good crack having an American boy.
She's fucking lunatic.
Is she gullible?
Yeah, they're so
well.
She's more fucking energy than I do. I'm trying to keep up with her, like, you know.
Yeah.
But I love that as well. Like,
we used to tell him that we didn't have Wednesdays in Ireland, and he used to believe it.
Yeah, it was just a 6-day week.
Yeah, we used to say that to him, like Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and he used to be like,
"When
you
say it, does sound very convincing."
But and yeah, and they believe it. Like,
yeah.
How would you believe that? You know what I mean? That's how blatant gullible they are.
Yeah,
so you probably told her I'm a big DJ in Ireland and she believed that, you know what I mean?
Funny thing is, though, she's never been to one of my gigs because of the fucking pandemic, so like, we'll probably be broken up.
Yeah.
She'll see me at one of my gigs and she'll be like, oh, fucking not
I'm not showing up at this show.
Nah, but like, that, you asked me what I want to do in the next couple of years, and yeah, we want to just kind of get out there. And
I mean, you have a big record deal. The residency is next, isn't
Stop.
It?
Well, like, the residency in Ireland have been fun. And I've done China, you know, I've done...
Fuck off.
Been Croatia, Ultra.
You me, played in China?
Played in... So Macau is south of China. It's like a kind of separate to China, but it's like the Vegas of Asia. And there's a club over there. Oh my God, I completely forgot.
You kept that quiet. Imagine like, oh yeah, just DJing.
You go through the whole podcast.
So it says you're fucking DJing in China.
Funny, I'll tell you. I went for a weekend because I had my spin show and I didn't want to... I couldn't take time off work to go. So flew out to Friday.
I take it a weekend to get there.
It do well, yeah, a day, yeah. But did the gig on the Saturday.
A day to get to China.
Yeah.
How would you take a day to get to China and a day to get to Australia as well?
Because they're on the other side of the world, parents.
Are they close to each other? They're not that close to each other, Eddie.
I fucking hate this podcast. can't believe you had to get 43
that's
episodes.
That's a rap, boys, yeah.
43 episodes, and it took Marty Guilfoyle to fucking wrap this up. I hate this podcast.
You're supposed to be dropping the knowledge on me,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah, he said you sound like an owl.
An owl? Who said that, Marty, did you? dirty doggy, you kept that quiet.
Yeah, I did. Should
I hear what he said there?
Who?
What a fucking idiot.
Nice. Yeah, we went to Macau anyway, and I woke up, I finished the gig in Pacha, the Pacha nightclub. And someone told me that Hong Kong is a half an hour away in a boat. Hong Kong, fuck, it's 4-5 in the morning. Like, you know, I was like, I'm not going to fucking bed. I'm going to Hong Kong. And the lads that were with the team were like, oh, fucking, we're going to bed. We got a flight tomorrow night. And I was like, fuck off. So we hopped on a boat, went to Hong Kong for 3 hours, came on the boat back, just walked around. It was like, can't come over that far and not see
Hong Kong. Not? Like,
and then, hopped on the flight back and was back in Spain then the next day to do my radio show.
Lit.
So,
what's up?
Yeah.
It's a bit of crack, that.
That
anyway,
was
shouldn't
a bit
it?
Of crack, yeah.
You and kept that word. We're everywhere thinking, like, oh, this fella, fair play. Not to get a record.
Yeah, you didn't go over your ears back on my Instagram. You
we
obviously
didn't
just
go
scrolled a little.
Because we're not creeps, Marty. No, you know what I mean? We let you tell us what you want to tell us, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
We'll ask you the questions.
Like we said, it's not an interview. It's just a little chat with the boys.
A chat about Calippos and fucking Marty Morrissey.
Two boys on the flats interviewing a posh DJ.
Yeah.
This is episode 43, isn't it?
That's a rap, isn't
no,
it?
No, it's not a rap, because one thing I want to bring up, and I'm surprised you haven't brought it up, right? We talked about this the first time we met you, Marty. Tell us about that time that you roasted Terrence on TikTok.
Oh, stop.
Actually.
You can't. You're fucking, I love you right now, man. Oh, so.
Oh, fucking hell. And
I was trying.
Well.
I was finding ways to promote my new track, and there was a hashtag trending, and it was Kitchen Hacks. And I was like, I'm going to fucking post anything here so people hear the song. Something that people will watch and, you know, get annoyed over just so they could hear the song. And I was like, fuck it. I'll cut my pizza with a scissors. And you come at me.
Yeah.
You come at me. We did that already. Fucking. And then I went back and I was like, oh, he fucking, who's this chap?
No,
I went and I got the date of when you did it and the date of when I posted TikTok and left them. And you were, to be fair, man, you took it like a boss. You were like, oh, shit, yeah.
You got tagged in L sometimes. You getting tagged in it. I was. He was tagging me going, look, he's at the stroke. And that's what he bounced.
Yeah, you fucking did. Yeah.
I was just you were stroking that all the
time. Hit you with the date. So it was a month before you.
Yeah.
But then we had a chat about this a few weeks ago. And we were like, hang on, it's not like cutting a pizza with a scissor. It's not exactly like
it's not groundbreaking.
It's not groundbreaking, like real creative. It's not like, you know, like I made a song and you made the same song after hearing it. Like it's a fucking scissors and a fucking pizza.
It was important to us. You played a big role in that episode.
Yeah. People hated it. People were giving out to me going, is that the same scissors you use to cut the paper and stuff?
Yeah.
Hygiene and all.
Oh, we had more on this.
It's a fucking TikTok.
We had more on the podcast about this. And a lot of on Instagram, it blew up. A lot of people blew up
over the scissors and the pizza.
Yeah.
It's fucking handy though, isn't it? Like, just stick it in the dishwasher with everything else after you're done. Like.
Could you not just use a pizza cutter? Like,
we're not all that posh now, man, having a pizza cutter.
Exactly, man. You caught my zone. He's only had pizza cutters.
Yeah.
And then he was like, they come with gaff.
They come with your gaff.
The fucking...
You buy a brand new gaff that's only being built. You go in, the place is deserted. Yeah, it's
and
like that scene from Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Will Smith walks in, the gaff is empty.
Nah.
There'll be a fucking pizza cutter in the kitchen. And that's all.
That's not a fucking... I don't have a pizza cutter at home. So now, you want to go back to that...
You're worth the fortune and you don't have a
pizza
cutter.
Let's go back to that definition of posh, stylishly luxurious. I don't have a fucking pizza cutter.
Love
so you can take that posh comment back now. You're the posh one here.
It's called.
You're the fucking posh one. Hang on. You're putting on the accent. You're the posh one deep down. There we go.
Smart,
that's a wrap. Episode
hard.
33. Marty Guilfoyle. Thanks.
He has that little thing wrapped up, doesn't he? Marty Guilfoyle.
Marty Guilfoyle.
Boy, episode 33. Marty Guilfoyle here. It's going to wrap it up. 10 spin hits in a row.
Well, but that is your rapping, anyways, isn't it?
Yeah,
Marty, give us your best Terrence impression before we go. Go on.
And I'll give you my best. Oh, I tried that Instagram memo. I couldn't do it.
Oh, I was fucking out last night and my mate got nicked.
Well.
Right, we'll wrap that up.
Wrap it up, boys.
10 spin hits in a row. Boom.
That's a wrap.
Subscribe to this podcast for free on the Go Loud app.
What you waiting for? Put your back in it. Just a little more. Throw your weight in it now. Till your body is dead. Walk it hard and long. When you feel it,
the hip knocker.